Hey, I know you don't smoke weed. I know this. But I'm gonna get you high today. Cause it's Friday. You ain't got no job. Shit to do.
Yo, it's your boy Big F, aka the Double Vodka Don, here with my co-host Young Wayne Jetski, the SoundCloud God.
Hello.
The real MVP of the podcast, producer Colin Cooper on the ones and twos. We are 808s and Smoke Breaks. We're back. You couldn't see this if you were not watching this, but that slide mic drop I just did was insane.
It was really good. I kind of...
Effortless.
I threw some shade at you at first because your claps, though, were not really that loud.
I don't have big hands.
You don't have big hands.
I have small hands. Admittedly, I have small hands.
Does that bother you at all?
No.
It throws off your proportions?
Nah, because it's weird, though, because then I have, like, good-sized feet. I'm, like, a size 11
yeah,
and a half.
Yeah,
I'm 11 and a half, and I'm, like, 5'10", 5'11", so, I mean, that's pretty, like, good size.
Did you do that as an excuse to show the kicks off?
Nah, my kicks are fresh, though.
Yeah, you are snapping again.
The new Prestos. Just copped them last weekend.
I'm wearing some Sherlock Holmes boots. But that works too.
Fucking the
Solve a Crime 2s.
Did Indiana Jones solve crimes?
No, he was an archaeologist.
Okay.
So he studied architects and artifacts. People would hire him to go into like the middle of nowhere, Egypt, and like they wanted this prize jewel that was stuck in a mountain or fucking a pyramid or something. So you'd get it and retrieve it.
So like the Searching for Rocks 13s.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, copy.
This is what Indiana Jones wore these.
Thick black laces.
Thick black laces are not bad. Whatever.
I wasn't hating. That was more of an observation.
It was an observation.
That was a very high observation.
I want to get right into it because this has been fucking me up. And I think the three of us probably aren't as educated as we need to be on this. What's going on with coronavirus? Are we scared? Are you guys scared? I'm fucking scared.
I'm not scared.
No. So I heard this today. So I was under the interpretation literally until about like probably 2 hours ago.
Okay.
That it was something that could just just kill you.
Yeah, you thought it was like the
bubonic
plague.
Now I was told that it's literally less than the flu. Like it's like a weak flu.
Yeah, but I think the issue is the like how contagious it is. It's spread airborne.
Okay. But I'm saying, but if it's like a weak flu, obviously no one wants the flu. But people are acting like it's this like deadly disease. Like it's just going to like touch your skin. Like they're acting literally like it's AIDS. Like they're acting like you're just going to get it and like they're acting like it's worse than AIDS. They're acting like you're going to get it, you're just going to like drop dead. That's the way it seemed to me from the outside, someone who lives his life with a head in the sand. Mm-hmm. It looked to me from the outside, just seeing like headlines and shit, that was what was going on.
Okay.
And then today I find out that it's not even as strong as the flu. And I'm like, who cares?
So the symptoms...
I've gotten the flu before. It sucks.
Before you go into it, though, because I just heard about it, but I haven't like read about it. Where did patient one like get it from? Did it say?
I heard it was bad.
They haven't isolated.
No, I know that, but I'm saying like, were they in China and came back? Like that's what.
Yes, it started. It started in Asia.
No, I know where it started. I'm saying this person. Yeah, like did they say where they came from, or have they been in the States the whole time?
There's 35 cases of it in the States.
Is it really?
35 cases.
Well, yo, one was on Long Island.
No, that's not true. So there's
Nassau County, I thought.
No, 80 people voluntarily submitted themselves to quarantine on Long Island in Nassau County because they were just in China. And when you're in quarantine, they left China because of coronavirus.
Right.
And as soon as they got there, they submitted themselves to make sure they're not spreading it. So they're giving them tests. I don't think the test results have come back yet. Or five of them have came back or something like that. And they were all negative, but not all of them came back.
People are taking it real seriously.
People are going to get coronavirus. Like it's going to happen.
You know what I'm saying? I just feel like people are taking it like super, super, super serious. Like it's going to be like it's so, so, so bad.
They're taking it serious because
it's probably not great.
It's no, but spreading it's, but like saying, crazy. No, there's
no cure for
it.
Obviously, it's not great, but I don't want it. But I'm saying like if it's less than the flu, like
yeah, I heard it's like a respiratory infection.
People get the flu all the time.
Yes, but if you're a baby or you're old, you're fucked. If you get the flu, you're dying.
Really?
Not necessarily a baby, but it's really bad. If you're really, really young or really, really old or have a bad immune system, the flu can take you out.
So
and if you think about it, a lot of the population, not a lot, there's a high number of people in America who are really, really old and get sick easily and really, really young and get sick easily.
Fair.
It's not the majority of the population, but it's a lot of people.
It's more just the way, I mean, so I guess I'm understanding the precaution, but there's been some crazy, like, so my girlfriend was telling me, yes, like one of her like best friends, brother who's in college had this overseas like whatever a semester abroad
mm-hmm.
planned for like a year basically, and they were literally supposed to leave I think tomorrow.
Yep.
And yesterday he found out that they like just canceled the whole thing. Like everyone who was supposed to go, it was like not just him, it was like maybe a group of like 150 people. that were all supposed to go, and they just canceled it like the day before.
There's a couple outbreaks
planned for months. Like, and it sucked because then they couldn't register for classes because it's like a month and a half in already. Mm-hmm. So they'd be literally taking it that serious that they're canceling like a year long planned trip and making like a group of like 150 kids literally just take a semester off of school.
Yeah.
Like that's what I was saying. Like it literally, I was like, yo, like people must be just like dropping dead from this shit.
People in China are,
you can't even remotely come near it.
Well, I'm reading this. It's not about coronavirus. It's just about the flu in general. But it says that CDC predicts that at least 12,000 Americans will die from the flu in any given year. As many as 61,000 people died in 2017 through that 2018 flu season, and 45 million were infected.
No shit. I mean,
it's definitely serious.
That many. I didn't know that many people died from the flu
all the time, bro.
That was 61,000 in 2 years, in 17 and 18 combined?
No, just I think the 2017 to 2018 series.
No way.
Said 14,000 people died and 250,000 people were hospitalized during last year's flu season.
Well, I'm dumb.
The issue is there's a vaccine, a regular flu vaccine. There's not a vaccine, and that's numbers of the flu. But there's not a coronavirus vaccine at all. So that's why people are freaking the fuck out. Enough. And in China, there's 80. They predict now it's 88,000 cases of it.
Wow. So yeah, I mean, I'm stupid.
And the area that it started in, Wuhan,
not stupid. Misinformed.
They're like closed off from the world. It's like it's like a desolate city. The area where coronavirus broke out. It looks like what New York looked like in the I Am Legend movie, like just desolate. There's no one out in the streets. All these all these images that have come out. And there's
I've seen that. It's
there's a video
creepy.
That went viral. Some people said it was fake of someone like in a high rise apartment building outside in China. And there's like 15 other buildings around it, and you just hear shrieking, like these people are screaming because apparently the Chinese government is barricading people where they like whole buildings where they're suspected coronavirus and just welding like the doors shut and just locking people.
Oh my God.
Yeah. But no one knows what's going on in China. They're like suppressing all information right now. And like there's some people think that they're doing that. Some people also think that they're burning dead bodies of people who have it. So there's an empty field outside of Wuhan that's giving off an amount of SO2, and SO2 is like a byproduct of burning human matter or just organic matter being given off in this random field, like a couple miles from the city. There's more SO2 being given off than in the actual city itself. So that's what they think that, and like some data scientists did the data, like how much SO2 emission how much SO2 is emitted when one body is burnt in the air, and calculated the information for how much SO2 was in the air there. And he was able to like calculate there's a, could be 13,000 people being burnt. Or they've burnt 13,000 people in this field, maybe dead, maybe alive. That's just a theory that I read on Reddit, conspiracy theory. So take that with a grain of salt.
Oh, well, I mean, you
heard it here first
from
808s and Smoke Breaks.
But
you rifled that whole thing off to me, and then
it's real data.
It was a Reddit conspiracy theory.
Conspiracy theories are also often right. Jeffrey Epstein.
So what's the
whole pedophile?
So what's your believability that they actually are running up in houses and like welding them shut, like apartment buildings?
I totally could see that being a thing, and that's happening in China.
That's fucking like, could you imagine?
It's a communist government.
I live
you
live
hear
in
the stories about
building.
What Donnie says? Like they've done like fucked up shit to people for less. Like he said that people got caught smoking weed and like at a club, and then they had to tattle on. The government told them, give us four of the people who are smoking weed, we'll let you go. And people he knew, like expats. I might be butchering a story Donnie told me, but so we have to get him on to corroborate this. But people he knew, like they showed up at his house. The government like just arrested them for smoking weed, like for someone saying they smoked weed. They do crazy shit out there.
Damn, China's really, they're really savage.
Communist country.
Savage as fuck.
Yeah, also, like, it's where that shit started. They're trying to suppress all the information about it. And
I wish China wasn't so strong that we could just, like, fuck them up, like, easy.
Like, know, like so there's people.
That's what I'm saying. There's no reason, like, I mean, I'm not, like, not a big war guy.
War guy. Thank you for prefacing your comment with not a big
but
war
I
guy.
But I mean, that it's not worth it to go to war with them.
Definitely not.
Because
I feel like they'll just stop at nothing too.
Dude, I would never want. Like, I'm not saying we would lose, but I think
be tough.
We
would fuck up the economy really bad.
No
one
wants to smoke with us, but they do be flooding us with shit for the low.
I'm trying to pull.
Honestly, let's call it what it is. China's the plug.
China is the plug.
China's the plug.
Everything like that good. That good knockoff merchandise and that good coronavirus.
And see, this is how you have to realize the plug. Like when you think about like your weed plug, whatever plug, like. He doesn't have to be like the best guy in the world.
I'm not
like co-signing the plug. I just go to the plug because I need goods for a low price, and he has quality goods at low prices. You don't have to. I mean, I don't know what he does when I'm not there. You know?
I guess so. I'm trying to find this fucking, this map of that says how many coronaviruses by, coronavirus outbreaks by country, but I'm not able to pull up. But do you guys think that we should start wearing masks or anything like that? Have you seen people doing that? Are you gonna gonna do masks?
That's one thing I want to comment on.
I struggle enough breathing as it is.
Asians have been wearing masks forever.
That's facts.
And people are now facts. Like seeing them on subways and like freaking out about it. Like, get the fuck.
It's
over
a cultural
it.
Thing.
I mean, yeah, too, they've always done that.
The
shit.
Air quality is terrible.
I was just gonna say the air quality there is shit.
I actually
even when they come like so. This big shop, this huge, it's the biggest outdoor shopping mall in the world. It's like the Woodbury Commons up by me. Like all tons of people from Europe, Asia go there just to shop. Mm-hmm. And even like years ago, like all the time, you see so many Asian people wearing masks.
I saw something today that said it's not really going to help that much. Like almost warning against it. But
I mean, it's just like, it's not even Asian people. You see any culture wearing
now,
that.
Now I see a bunch of it. Like when I flew...
But that's literally just like if you're sick, you don't want to infect other people, so you keep a mask on. So if you sneeze, you don't fucking sneeze out into the air. You know what I mean?
I feel like in theory it kind of helps though. So like these are the CDC prevention tips. Nowhere does it say to wear a mask. It just says avoid close contact with people who are sick, avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth, stay home when you're sick, cover your cough or sneeze with tissue. It's just regular, like typical, how not to get the flu shit. But I think that I kind of want to do the face mask because I think right now we could do some coronavirus merch, maybe a fucking Barstool coronavirus mask, and that shit could go fucking bananas. We need them. Let's get some fucking merch bonuses.
I don't hate that.
Right?
I don't hate money.
And if it looked like
I surely don't hate money.
I was saying to Quigs before, like we were saying, call her daddy should make one. It could just be like a blowjob mask. It's a coronavirus mask. It would probably sell a fucking 100,000 of them.
Like just a little trap door?
Yeah, a little trap door. And it just says call her daddy. Or call her daddy. And then you open the mouth, and the mouth is part that says daddy.
Huh.
And daddy puts the dick.
You think is it like a side flap?
I was thinking.
Like this is flip. Cause
yeah,
of
it has to be side.
That's what I'm saying, because it can't flip over top, because then it go over your nose and then maybe your eyes too.
And you give her the Arabian gas mask?
Ooh.
Oh, baby.
The Arabian gas mask.
It's the Arabian sand goggles.
Oh, I thought it was the gas mask.
When you put the nuts on the eyes?
When you put the nuts
on
the
eyes. Yeah, that's the Arabian sand goggles.
Oh, all right. Well, I was under the impression that it was the Arabian gas mask, but.
That's what happens when. See, when you have like when you have a larger scrotum like I do,
mm-hmm.
and you try to do the thing where the girl hangs her head backwards off the bed.
Yeah, we talked about that.
That's what happens. But yep. So I've definitely given a female or two the Arabian. What is it? The Arabian what? Goggles?
Sand goggles.
I think gas mask. I think they're kind of synonymous.
But there are two things going over your eyes. They're goggles. Two sand goggles.
Two big balls, just testicles, just resting on your face while you're trying to.
I'm glad I'm not a girl. I don't have to do that.
Yeah, that'd be brutal.
I'm going to go through one more last coronavirus thing. There's facial hairstyles that could prevent coronavirus. Shout out Hot New Hip Hop. I just keep stealing all your articles for topics.
Beards?
Yeah.
Beards
so,
help?
In the most dystopic news you've heard today, the CDC has released a chart indicating which facial hairstyles could interfere with potentially life-saving respirators. Basically, it's just you don't want a full beard. Like yours is a little thick. If it was a cleaner trim, you'd be okay. But
what about when I just get a haircut? I'm due for one.
That's good. So okay. Basically,
so
it's just
gotta touch it up.
If you need a filtering face piece respirator in the event that coronavirus gets like really bad and we all have to wear these so it doesn't spread, it's gonna be like tough for you with your beard. So be a little bit more clean shaven.
But I'm saying if it was a little thinner. But I still have the same like shape, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
It would be good.
I don't know.
Are you saying clean shaven's the best way?
Yes, because then the face mask
beards.
Is stuck to your face.
I thought you were saying beards helped.
No.
Oh, so I'm fucked.
Yeah, you want to if you have a clean trim,
it's
beard,
all
okay.
up in there, Ev.
But yeah,
oh, Ev's got so big. Ev's got all risk. That coronavirus in the beard.
What fuck?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't necessarily saying that. It was just saying like. If it does come to the point where like we need to wear the masks,
like
you have to go clean shaven.
Imagine in a month or two or whatever that we were in a point where every single person just had to wear a mask.
It could happen in like 6 months.
Yeah, honestly, I'd get a fire ass mask.
If you were in China right now, you'd be wearing one. With 88,000 people in the country having
it? Yeah, probably, yeah.
I'd be wearing one regardless.
I'd wear a fire ass black one. I'd get a black mask.
Donnie has a bunch of cool ones.
Maybe put like a little Raiders, like that Raiders logo kind of thing on it. Not an actual Raiders logo, but that skull crossbones type. Maybe some diamonds.
I think we really, we're going back to like almost the merch. I think we really have something here designer face masks. I know they're a thing already.
We need to get in front of it, because then if we're ready to go to market, so when it pops off, when everyone needs one, we'll be like, yo, we got them right here. We can ship them. You can have it tomorrow.
All
right,
we
got
to get in the
matter of fact, you can have it right now. I've got a couple in my backpack. I'll sell you one right now, $100.
We should start slanging them on the street.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe on the street in New York, like, all right, we get some knockoff brands for like 20.
Our downfall, though, is coronavirus being like solved or cured. So we need to keep it going.
Then we just sell them back to China because they like them there. Originally.
Yeah, they need them no matter what. Because if they become big in the United States, then China will follow.
China will follow.
They listen to all our music and shit.
Yeah.
So we get a couple artists that we have interviewed, they pop off, put them in a mask. Then all of a sudden, then they see on a billboard, then when them at our concert or on Instagram, then they're like, damn, he's got a mask. So I want a mask. And we start slanging them in Europe.
It's just going to, I feel like if we started the trend of wearing the mask, man, people would follow, but it's going to be tough to be the first person that you know start wearing a mask.
Dude, people already wear fucking masks.
Do you know anybody, any of your friends who are wearing a mask right now walking around?
No, but none of my friends would.
Should
we just be the trendsetters, the pioneers?
Or we'd get so roasted.
And just, nah, fuck it. You just got to lean into it. But the only thing is, if you are the mask guy, you have to commit.
That's the
like
thing.
You have to be the mask guy, not like when you feel like it, not like when it's convenient for you. You got to be the mask guy all the time.
I'm not committing to mask guy.
You're either in or you're out.
Are you committing to mask guy?
I'm thinking about it.
Okay, you're either in or you're out.
No, but I'm seriously.
You always do this. You always like try to pressure me into making a decision that you wouldn't make, but make me think you make the decision.
No, I'm seriously considering it.
Whatever.
It's a real thought. If I don't be shocked if next week I walk in with a black mask.
I don't think that if we're going to sell them, we have to wear them. But I understand where you're coming from. Whatever though.
I need a nice mask.
What do you think about this guy from ESPN saying that Tom Brady is unlikely to sign with the Pats?
Yeah. I call bullshit.
I think it's cap. Yeah,
my thing is
it's just one of those things. Like, I'll believe it when I see it. I hope so, because I just love to see. I love to see just like anarchy, and I know like things will just go crazy.
But
like,
I don't.
It'll just be media anarchy. Everyone's just gonna go nuts if this happens.
Who's the fucking Patriots backup?
Well, I mean, it's not really. I mean, Jared Stidham is. They drafted him in like the third or fourth round this year last year out of Auburn. He played a little bit. He didn't look great, but I mean, he's a rookie. I mean, but I'm saying also, I think if that was the case, they would make like, if they didn't sign Brady, they're making like a big move. Like, they're either like making a huge jump, like up in the draft, like drafting somebody, or they're getting like, they're signing a free agent. I don't know who.
You think they have something like planned? This is a ridiculous concept. But what if they have like some crazy deal with like Cincinnati where they're going to send like a bunch of picks to Cincinnati for Joe Burrow? Cause they know like Joe Burrow says he's not going to play for Cincinnati.
It would be too much. Cause where they are in the draft, like they're like 20 something, like 20, probably
I'm saying future picks or
26. No, but I'm saying even that, like no team is moving from like 1 to 26. Think about how badly they need.
What
to,
if
like,
they send Tom Brady? They're not going to send Tom Brady.
No, they wouldn't. They're like, yo, we can just have the rookie. Yeah. Like, why would we want this guy when we're ass? Like, just going from, like, 20, whatever, like, mid-20s to 1 is such... The price is, like... I think I would need every first-round pick you have for the next, like, decade.
The thing, though, like, the Patriots, because they're always, like, the 29th pick it doesn't matter then because they're so good every year that they still somehow upgrade without even drafting. You know, they have these steals
I think this year they took a step back for sure.
Dude, they still went to the fucking playoffs.
They're the Patriots.
They're always going to have that next man up mentality.
And the thing is, like with Brady, it's like, the whole like, if they don't want him, they don't want him. I don't think that's the case. But say hypothetically, they didn't want him. Like New England, without a doubt, in my mind, is the best case scenario, the best chance he has to win the Super Bowl.
Who, Tom Brady?
Yeah, with the Patriots. Where else is he going to go and win the Super Bowl? Because he's not like 2012 Tom Brady.
Yeah, no facts.
Like he's not going to throw 50 touchdown passes. And if you think he's going to go into a new offense, and just light it up, like he's
at this.
Like,
point,
I think he'll play well. Like he'll play probably similar to what he did this year.
At this point, the Patriots owe him a payday, so he's going to get paid by them. He deserves it, and like you said, He's not going to go somewhere and learn a new offense. His best chance to win a Super Bowl is in New England easily. He knows the team. He knows the system. He knows the players. There's no doubt that they're going to move on from Brady within the next 5 years because they need a future. But I don't ever count him out just because of what you always
say. I think they're, without a doubt, they're drafting someone this year or making some sort of move.
Well, their backup right now isn't terrible.
I don't think they're not ready to commit to Jameis.
No, 100%. But they're not going to have to.
But I'm saying I think they're going to make a move this year, either like whether they move up and draft like a Herbert.
They'll probably go
like
out.
That would be a crazy move. But I'm just saying, like, not even Herbert. But I'm just saying, like, I'm saying, I think there's somebody.
I don't think this year.
I just threw Herbert out just as a name. But I'm saying, like, I think there's somebody that Bill Belichick has his eye on.
If we ever see Tom Brady leave the Patriots, which I don't think is likely, but if we saw him, like, somehow, like, people were saying, whatever, he goes to Chargers or some shit, just, like, hypothetically somehow, you know, what will we realize? That Tom Brady is not as good as we thought, or Bill Belichick isn't as great as we thought?
Bill Belichick's great.
Yeah. That's what I think.
So, they went 11-5 with Matt Castle.
Yeah. I think it would ruin, it wouldn't tarnish Tom Brady's legacy, but I think it would knock it down a little bit.
Tom Brady can do nothing to tarnish his legacy.
You don't think if he goes to like a team and has one fluke season where he like,
no,
people will talk, but still, no.
Maybe he's not the greatest.
People will talk shit, but no, I don't think it tarnished. The guy's won 6 Super Bowls. His legacy is fine.
I'm at the point where, like, obviously as a Jets fan, like Jetski, I used to absolutely despise Tom Brady, like hate the Patriots, the passion, like bring me back to the Rex Ryan era. Like, that was so much fun. The Jets haven't been good in so long that I'm at the point where I'm cool with Tom Brady.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know what? If he wins another Super Bowl with the Patriots, so fucking be it. Because that's all he's done in my entire, like, I don't know.
Probably the entire time.
Oh, my whole life. I mean, pretty much my whole life.
No, after the Atlanta one, I threw in the towel.
Oh, yeah.
I used to, like, chirp as a Giants fan.
Yeah, then I was like, fuck this.
And the Eagles one, as much as I, like, love to see them lose, just the Patriots lose, it was annoying to not be, like, we're specifically the kryptonite.
Yeah.
Like, we'll always have it over the Pats fans, no matter what.
My that was the one time I've ever rooted for the Patriots in the Super Bowl, because my ex-girlfriend at the time, we had just broken up, like, a year ago.
She was a Giants fan?
From Philly. Oh, no, and she's an Eagles fan. And the Eagles never won a Super Bowl ever. So I was like, let's fucking go, Patriots. And they blew it. And I was like, you motherfuckers.
Fuck you, bitch.
The only time a Jets fan I was ever rooting for the Patriots.
I don't think I've ever rooted. I don't think I've ever rooted for the Pats.
Might literally have to cut that.
I just remember after
you have to cut that.
I came in. It was that. So I was in the frat at the time, and we had like a good amount of Pats fans. Two of them I was like real close with that were like one of them, like one of my best friends that was a big Patriots fan. And after that Super Bowl, like just watching these scumbags like pop champagne and shit in our like back deck after they were down fucking 28-3 at the end of ending to the third quarter. I remember I came in the next day from class and they both were just sitting in the room and I just happened to see like a white paper towel right there and I picked it up. I just threw it. I was like, yo, like I'm done. I was like, any bad things I've said about Brady, I was like, it's over. I was like, he's the GOAT. I was like, that's it. I was like, I'm not mad about it anymore. I'm not going to like hate anymore. Like, I'll never bet against him again. Like, it's just,
is that true? You haven't bet against him since that
game? I have like just in games, but like just I'll never bet against him. Like, that they can't like go to the end of the year and get it done.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Like I bet those spots, I'll like bet against them, spread, whatever. But like, I will never like, even this year, I was like, yeah, like they go win the Super Bowl this year.
I mean, there's an article out every single year that's like, the Jets are poised to take over the Patriots series. Like, the Bills sure are poised to take the Patriots series.
The Bills are making
never the
steps.
Dolphins, but like, it's just crazy. It's every single year they're there. That's why it's just like whatever now.
Don't sleep on the Jets. We're gonna get Jerry Jeudy in the green.
Yeah, we'll see. I'll take Lamb
too.
What
pick too. You guys have
11.
But all right, so he could be there.
Are we 13? We're there.
I think Jeudy will be gone before that. He's such a stud.
CeeDee Lamb.
Yeah, Lamb. I think Jeudy is a prize.
Oh, 100%.
I think we need him in New York though, the most Jews in the country are probably in New York, Florida, and California.
They were talking about him potentially being a Giant, but I don't think Gettleman will take
a receiver. He's meeting with the Jets this I think next week.
We're gonna take Okuda or somebody. Who I'm fine with. Okuda is such a stud.
I love where he was just like, he's like, yeah, they call me Jew for short. So I got to change.
Yeah, Jew.
Yeah, then he tweeted like, out. He's like, I'm sorry.
He's like, my last name, Judy. Yeah. They call me Jew.
Dude, but he's got fucking takeoff speed that I've never seen.
He's
before.
Massive.
I mean,
massive.
Watching him just catch a slant route and then fucking.
How tall is he? Like 6'3"?
Yeah.
He's skinny though.
Yeah, he's skinny.
Yeah, but he's a receiver, so like fucking
fast. He's got like a Robbie Anderson.
He's probably 6'3", 215.
He's bigger than Robbie Anderson for sure.
You saw him play, right? Obviously.
Oh, dude, yeah. No. Dude. I didn't see him. I wasn't at Alabama then.
Really?
I graduated in 2016.
I've seen him on TV a bunch of times, and that boy is a problem.
I mean, yeah, on TV, but not he wasn't there when I was there.
He is
there.
A problem.
I thought maybe he was like a freshman when you were there.
No.
Problem. And fucking Henry Ruggs is saying he's going to run 4.2.
Is there a lot of Jews in Alabama? Like, you think he...
No, how? No. Then there can't be.
Yeah, I didn't think so. So maybe he's like...
the Bible belt.
Maybe he didn't know... yeah, facts. It's not the fucking Torah belt.
Hell no.
Maybe he just... I mean, he didn't say anything offensive. Like, he didn't say anything wrong.
No, he was just apologizing because, like... I don't know. Calling someone a Jew could be looked at in a bad way, but his is like, oh, I mean, it's my last name, like Jew.
Especially
Jew.
Like draft time, they get super. Like you're not trying to do anything to fuck your money up.
Fun fact: I think I've said this before. Kodak Black is Jewish. He changed his name to Bill Capri.
So is Amari Stoudemire is half Jewish?
No,
or full Jewish
by choice, or did he convert? He definitely
no,
converted,
I think
right?
he even
you guys just naming famous Jewish people.
I guess now, yeah,
Adam
famous,
Sandler's
famous
Jewish.
People.
Okay. No, but we're saying black people.
Either black, oh, black people,
like Drake.
There's, like, I don't think traditionally
Drake's
like,
half Jewish.
And Drake is half Jewish from his mom, I think.
Yeah. Well, yeah, the white one.
And they talk about in Uncut Gems, there's like a tribe of Ethiopian Jews.
Hasidic Jews.
Ethiopian Hasidic Jews. And that's why Kevin Garnett wanted the stone, because he wanted to harness the power of Jews from Ethiopia.
Hey, he played great.
He did play great.
Yep.
What a fucking movie that was, huh? What an
I guess,
ending.
But do you think if Jerry Judy converts to Judaism, he'll help his draft stock?
No.
Because if he didn't hurt
I think it could help his game.
I don't think it matters.
Shout out to all the Jews out there.
I mean, he could probably be more just frugal with his money.
So how do we get there, Tom Brady?
Yep. He's staying. I did want to bring this up, though. There was some rumor today that the Giants were interested.
In Tom Brady?
Yes.
Dude, that's not
which is so crazy. I was like, yo, if he came and played for the Giants, I'd be all for it.
That'd be
like,
such a slap in the face.
Dude, I'd be all for it. I'd be like, fuck it.
You guys were all last year, oh, yeah, Daniel Jones, number six. Then you'd be like, I sucking mean, no, on Tom Brady's
but,
knob.
But I'm saying he's still like, the future, I think, would still be Daniel Jones.
Do you honestly think he's the future?
I think he
that's
is.
Fine. Like, yeah. No.
He showed a lot of flashes.
You're talking a lot less fucking shit that you were during the season.
No. But
you were very high up.
But saying he's the future is like a big question.
Yeah, I think like he's promising.
Like I don't think Sam Darnold's the future. I think he could be.
Yeah, I think he's the future.
I don't think he. I'm oh, I think he's no. I think he's the future in the sense that like the Jets are just gonna. He's not in a good organization right now. The Jets are just gonna work him for years until they ruin him, and then it's just gonna be another quarterback that we went through.
I think we need to see him play a full season.
Well, we need an offensive line, that's for sure. But.
I think that if the Jets might have a 4-year plan in motion.
I'll answer Daniel Jones is the future.
Thank you.
If you said yes
program.
Or no, I'll say yes.
Yeah.
Because he just showed me too much like good stuff to just like quit on him.
He's fucking
like,
22.
He fumbled a lot, and that was a big problem. He fumbled a lot, like a lot.
He even got assaulted by Jamal Adams.
Yeah, he did.
You need to think about it. He's playing in fucking ACC. Like, he's playing against ferocious, huge, big men. Everyone in the
please.
NFL. Like, he's
weak as fuck.
That's what I'm saying. He's getting, like, really manhandled. He's probably, and he's a big dude. He's probably one of the bigger dudes in the field
he's tall,
when he was playing
five,
in college. And now, like, there's big dudes to throw the body around. Yeah.
I mean, he's a good athlete, too. He can just make plays. He throws a pretty ball. My thing with him is fumbling, you can fix. Yeah. Fumbling is fixable.
Yep.
And that's why I'll say yes.
Also, all right.
But I mean, he showed me a lot of good stuff.
One last question then. Are his outfits the future? Are his game day outfits the future?
Yo, he needs to get swagged up.
No, he doesn't. That's him.
He's literally Eli. It's just
bad.
Better looking.
No, Eli's better than
he's
that.
He's just Daniel.
I'm saying he's Eli. Like, he's Eli's just like a doof. He's like a better looking doof.
He's just Daniel.
I don't think Daniel Jones has drip.
He doesn't.
We have the cool. Sam Darnold is way cool.
Real swag is no swag.
Yeah, he has no swag.
Daniel Jones is
his is just fucking nerdy. Like, he walks in and he's got his hands in his pocket and he's like,
but then he might go give you 40.
Who cares?
Fuck this guy.
Dude, Sam Darnold's out here getting mono like a loser.
Yeah, because he's fucking girls.
Yeah, he's not, he probably didn't even get pussy. He probably literally just made out.
Sam Darnold definitely.
Sam Darnold is
so many girls.
Actually, honestly, the funniest part is I was literally about to say, like, Sam Darnold goes like the same places that like we do, but so does Daniel Jones.
Yeah, so you think either
Daniel Jones goes to Green Rock? I go to Green Rock all the time.
Some Hoboken thought will hurl herself at Daniel Jones in 2 seconds.
Yeah, but
Sam Darnold will pull it though.
Yeah, but no, but yeah, but see, Sam Donald's like a douchebag.
No,
like
he's
Sam,
not.
Like Sam Donald, probably. I don't know.
Not at all.
How do you know? Sam, he's from Cali, bro.
Yeah, but I'm saying he probably like has a girlfriend, weed. And he's just like crushing pussy. Like Daniel Jones is like loyal boys.
Cool.
Daniel
I guess.
Jones is being loyal. Oh, just being loyal to your girl is not cool.
I want my quarterback to be like Broadway Joe.
Yo, Colin, cut that. You gotta cut that, man.
I gotta be. I'm careful now. My girlfriend's friends listen to this podcast.
Shout out Bay's friends.
Yeah, I gotta be careful.
No,
but I mean, but that Daniel Jones, like Daniel Jones is loyal boys.
Shout out loyal boys.
Team loyal boys.
Loyal boys. Shout Sam out the loyal boys.
Sam Darnold.
Loyal
boys. Sam Darnold is like shit faced at fucking, what's the place called?
We Bounce.
Bounce in the city. I have had some great times.
Who'd you rather hang out with?
Sam Darnold, no doubt.
Thank you.
But I mean,
Sam, we love you, bro. Come on the podcast.
But Daniel Jones, I think Daniel Jones has way more promise.
Oh, for sure. No lie. What? I agreed with you because I was trying to go through articles.
No, for sure. No lie.
I was like, no way.
That was weird. This has became like a football podcast.
Yeah, we got to transition back into something.
It's like 20 minutes.
We didn't talk about any
Giants
music at all.
Giants and Jets quarterbacks.
And coronavirus.
Yeah.
I want to preview Sway Lee's new song. Or I guess.
Is it out already?
It's out on. It was out on Apple Music. It's supposed to come out tomorrow. I read, but I'm going to see if I can get it. Tell me if the sound fucking sounds terrible. Me playing right here with this mic, I'll stop. But he flipped his. Someone said
the vocals from Sicko Mode. Right?
He turned it into a song. So I really want to see how that turned out.
Huh.
Oh. I have the fucking. Someone said Sway Lee.
So sad.
It's out on Apple Music. I can't just fucking play it through my fucking phone. Hold on. Let's see. Can you sign it to Apple Music on a computer?
What's it called?
Someone said. I have him playing in the studio. I'm just going to play it off my phone and put my phone up to the mic. It's going to sound bad, but I'll figure out a way to download it and we can figure it out later. But I know it's on Apple Music. I think it's on Apple Music. It was at least.
Probably.
Is that on YouTube?
Yeah.
I don't think that's the right one.
Someone said. Someone said.
Maybe it's not out. Did I just fuck this up?
It drops at midnight, bro.
I saw an article where it was in the fucking. You could play it in the article. I played a little bit of it, but just the beginning. I might have just.
Yeah, that definitely wasn't it. That was probably like a techno remix.
Damn.
It's got finessed by YouTube.
I just got finessed by YouTube and fucked it up.
I'm saying all the music comes out at midnight. That's like the thing now. That's the wave.
No, it's right here.
I was play that bitch.
Might just be a.
Okay, there we go. Phelps.
I guess
it's low key a vibe.
I don't know, but it's not pulling up on my fucking Apple Music when I look on my phone. It might be an exclusive they got. I guess not the full thing. So I guess I just fucked this up. But
whatever, you heard some of it.
We heard some of it. Like going off it, it sounded pretty sick. A little underwhelming. I don't. But I didn't also.
See, my thing is, I could just that beat and like his flow. It's not even like about what he says. I could just see being in the club fucked up and just like swaying back and forth.
That or it's like something you listen to like headphones with really nice bass in it and you just like smoke.
Yes, sir.
Fuck yes.
I just felt that as soon as you played, I was like, just feel that little wave back and forth.
Damn, they finessed it. So that's what it was. It's available in select international markets right now. So
it's midnight.
That was just
when you were listening to this podcast, the song will be out.
The song will be out. Yeah. So I just fucked up. You're gonna hear it before we were able to hear it. Damn, that fucking sucks. But
we just heard that piece.
We heard a little piece.
I heard enough.
I'm just excited to hear a song that's like a flip of another song. Like where that was so iconic at that part of Sicko Mode where he decided to build his own song around. That's pretty cool.
I love it.
That's a very fire thing.
And Lil Baby's dropping music.
Lil Baby's dropping music this week.
It's called My Turn, I believe. An album.
Who else is dropping a single? You said some Rich the Kid dropping a single?
Yeah, Rich the Kid's dropping a single. G Herbo's dropping an album.
G Herbo's dropping an album that features a posthumous verse from Juice WRLD. That should be pretty cool. It's always cool to hear new Juice shit.
So the
he's not here anymore.
Okay, so I have the track. Wow. So the Lil Baby album has 20 songs on it. A lot of features. It has. He has a song with Gunna, as expected. He has a song with 42 Doug. I'm not familiar with him.
Not familiar.
So he has a song with Future, a song with Uzi, a song with Wayne, a song with Moneybagg Yo, a song with Thug, and a song with Rilo Rodriguez.
I feel like
20 songs.
Rilo Rodriguez is his artist. Is his artist?
Yes.
Signed.
20. Yeah, it's 20 songs, 1 hour, 1 minute.
That's a lot of music.
It is. I'm in on it.
I'm very excited to hear that. Well, maybe that'll be one of a song off. That'll be one of the slaps for next week.
Definitely. I love Lil Baby.
He's fire.
Lil Baby is probably my favorite person, like from kind of like the new school. That's the new school, but that's like also like established, like the established new school.
I would say I think he was post SoundCloud wave, Lil Baby. I guess
in a way, like, feels like he hasn't been on that long, but at the same time, he low-key has been on probably like
2 years,
like
maybe
2-3 years. Yeah.
2018, he started blowing up.
Probably because when did he drop, like, what was that first album with, like, the gray?
I'm not sure. The song that first got him on the map was Yes and, well, he was popular.
Harder Than Ever. Yeah.
It was called Freestyle.
That was 2018.
And then he got Yes Indeed with Drake.
Too Hard was 2017, and that shit was fire.
Lil Baby started was just a hustler, and they had used to pay him. I think we've said this before. Thug used to pay him to go to the studio and rap. Like you made your street money. Like, you're Val in the street. You're around us all the time. We would just want to, like, you should just rap.
I remember watching an interview with him where he basically said he hung out with, like, all the QC people because he just was, like, he was just known, basically, he just had money, was just, like, a trap god.
Yeah.
And they literally would try to get him to rap. He didn't want to. He went to jail for, like, a year or two, got out, was like, fuck it, I'll rap. And basically, he said he literally, it was crazy to hear him talk about it. He basically just, like, rapped, and it was, like, the first song he put out because he just had, like, QC behind him, and it is fire.
Yeah.
He basically just, like, literally, he was, like, 3 months, so I was basically a famous rapper.
That's so sick.
Like, he was like, I never really rapped before. He was like, I just started rapping and just, like, immediately just became a famous rapper. Within 1 year, he was, like, huge.
It was probably just, like, he was around, like, he grew up with all these guys, and, like,
I think he did.
QCP is, like, the
He knew all those guys. He literally would, like, hang out with them. Like, he said he, like, basically didn't do anything besides, like, basically was just a trapper, and, like, people in Atlanta just, like, knew who he was.
Yeah.
He just was, like, a name.
That's crazy. We got a very special interview coming up, a very interesting interview coming up.
It's very interesting.
Interesting intro, interesting outro. We have an interview coming up with Ethan Ross, rapper from New Jersey. He is a freestyle. We had Chris Patrick on, who spit a freestyle, crazy freestyle, but Ethan Ross is like a different type of freestyle, like just off the top, can just rap about literally anything.
No, he's very talented.
Very talented. He freestyles like at the beginning and end of the interview.
I was going to say, you'll see when this drops, he spits crazy at the beginning and two beats. I literally just picked the beats.
Mm-hmm.
The first one, I believe it was the Gucci Lemonade beat.
Yeah.
And the second one, I gave him a Millie.
He killed both.
Both like not easy. Lemonade a little easier. A Millie like not the easiest beat to rap to.
Not at all.
And he killed both of them. And the second one, we were literally like, Jetski was just throwing words at him.
Yeah, we gave him hot words.
And he was just using them to rap.
So shout out Ethan Ross. That interview is coming up right now.
Very impressive, dude. Very interesting, dude.
Very interesting.
Kind of like a different dude for the rap game. Like almost as like,
yeah.
I was just breaking his balls. I call him, what did I call him? Like, he was like, say something to make me laugh. When he took the picture, I was like, you look like a metrosexual painter.
He liked that.
He laughed.
He's a very cool dude.
He's kind of like an artsy look to him.
Yeah, I'd say.
But he's a very talented dude. He's very, very different dude.
For sure. Make sure you check that out after. We're gonna go take a smoke break, so if you want to, you know, indulge with us, do that, but come back and check out that Ethan Ross interview.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, I need a girl because I really don't cheat. Ethan Ross coming back on his beat. Hopefully I'm never gonna fall off. Ethan Ross, I just rap, I don't talk. I just run shit, I do not walk. They just wanna take me for a jog. I'm like, okay, I am a dog. Hop, 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 just like a frog. Right on the lily pad. Motherfuckers say I'm really bad. Can I curse? Do I dilly dally? And I got a girl and her name is Sally. No, I'm in the valley, no, I'm not talking Cali. More like Easton, more like Ethan, more like Beastin. I've been eating, no, I've been feasting. Brought the heat in. Do we get even or do I get I? My name Ethan Ross, I don't got a a squad. Shout out Isaiah. Isaiah Rashad? Coming back in on my job. That's a career right here. Ethan Ross got no fear right here. I want to move my seat right here. Ethan Ross beat my meat right here. I might just bust a nut. I hit him with uppercuts. So you know that I'm going to fuck it up. Baby girl, you want to take a shot of whiskey? Ethan Ross, like, are you drunk enough? I don't even really drink. I've been straight edge. I might break bread. I be like breaking eggs. I make an omelet and I flip it right up on the pan. Feel like a monster man. Feel like a contraband. Because I got crack. Crack it is on my hands. Because I'm a motherfucking walking drug. Know that I do this, I be talking love. And I just hit him over the head with the club. And I write back, don't give a fuck. Ethan Ross riding on a magic rug. Like my name was Aladdin, ay. You know that I have been gasping. You know that I'm back and rapping, ay. Ethan Ross feel like a savage, ooh, yeah. Splitting your cabbage, I gotta go get it. You know that I have it. In the past, I had a whole lot of bad habits. And now I just break it. I'm breaking the back and, breaking the back when I fuck her, ay. Ethan Ross smooth like butter, ay. I don't even really need a butler. Who am I? Batman? Need a cat scan because I hit him right in his head. Oh, Ethan Ross really, really off the edge. And I'm going back and need bread like it's wonder. Causing thunder, tear him asunder. Feeling like blunder. That is another word. That is another. Feel like I came from the gutter. Feel like I gotta go shout out. Hi to my mother. Hi to my mother. Like, how are you doing? Ethan Ross, all these rappers getting ruined. I don't give a fuck. I'm gonna fit my shoe in. You say those footprints too big.
Incorporate the banana.
Really, really fit. Oh, yeah. The banana is shit. Gonna eat banana with these chips that I also got. The veggie shit. Yeah, that's veggie. Ooh. And you know that my flow is so heavy. They said that my flow is so sexy. They said that my flow is so deadly. I feel like I need a machete. Feel like I'm Jason. All of this cash, know that I'm chasing. Know that I'm feeling my shit is adjacent. Feel like I'm gonna blow up, I'ma make it. Like my name Babyface, he gonna make it too. Ethan Ross, I'm a naked dude. Cause I take my clothes off and fuck you in the ass.
Whoa.
Whoa. Yeah, I'm doing so bad. Yeah, I'm doing so good. Am I terrible? I'm a lyrical, miracle, spiritual, individual. I'm a criminal in the swimming pool. And I do laps. Ethan Ross, no, I don't write raps. No, I go off the top of this shit. Your girl can be topping the whip. And I'm gonna go fast and I skirt off. Ethan Ross, you know that I don't talk. I just really speak like I'm giving these speeches. Living on beaches, cause I got my feet in the sand. Ethan Ross, there's no defeating the man. They're like, wait, he can? Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Walking like pedestrians. Walking this beat. Walking this beat. Know that Ethan, you cannot compete. I just got the heat. Got it in my pocket. Better switch topics. Oh no, shit. I just like chocolate. I eat chocolate. And a lot of it. That's why I'm fat. Just kidding, I'm skinny. Ethan Ross, damn right, I got plenty. Now I'm skinny, but I lost weight. Ethan Ross, damn, you cannot take my whole dick cause it's too big. Motherfuckers look stupid. I'm so violent, I'm putrid. Yeah, I just be that new kid on the block though. So my cock though, and I'm not slow. No, I go fast. Yeah, run up on me and I got a whole blade and I'm probably gonna get your fucking throat slashed. Then I let it leak out. Ethan Ross, how the hell a freestyle? You know I really like to speak now. Ethan Ross shining like decals. On the back of the car, gonna hold my dick while it's hard. You know that I gotta do this shit. And they wanna fight, no, they can't even really spar. Wanna box, she gon' give me box like it was UPS. Ethan Ross just like a UV ray. Hey, find me in USA Today. That is a newspaper, am I right? Gonna go ahead and I'ma put a fight up. Every time that I really put a knife up, old motherfucker run up, they get sliced up. I don't even notice shit. How the hell do you not notice this? Look at how broad and my shoulders get. The weight of the world, I've been holding it. Yeah, I don't gotta raise my voice. I just been making a choice.
No beat.
Yo, that was fun. Fire, bro. 4 minutes and 8 seconds. He didn't run out of rap. We ran out of beat. Oh my God.
Ethan Ross in the building.
For those of you who just tuned in, those of you who just might have gotten a cold open to what we're doing, that was Ethan Ross, aka Ethan Ross, the red hair. He is here on 808s and Smoke Breaks, and he just came in with a freestyle clearly off the top. That was crazy. We were giving you words to rap about. You had to put a banana. How are you fucking doing? You do this shit, huh?
I do. I was going to ask, is that the only rap segment in the interview? We're going to do another one later.
And we can definitely do
another one later.
We can do as much rap shit as you want. We definitely want to get to know you a little better first, but shit, bro.
I wanted to fit some shit in there to make people talk. Like, I feel like when I say, like, the really vulgar, like certain vulgar shit people like are uncomfortable with saying because they think it'll be suspect, but I just say
I like that.
You were throwing around suspect shit.
You said you made a fucker in the ass line, which I said gave me a little bit of I left it really ambiguous.
Ooh. So you didn't know if I was talking about a man or a woman.
That's awesome.
You gotta spice it up, leave mystery. That's what people always told me.
You gotta do that these days.
2020, you gotta leave mystery.
Make the ears perk up.
Ears
like
perk up.
Sometimes people ask me questions and I don't even answer them because I like to leave mystery.
I mean,
no, it's just like,
I love that, bro.
They're like, Ethan, like, how are you doing today?
Good. No answer.
No, like, I just
not even a whisper.
I don't say like.
So Ethan Ross, hailing from New Jersey. What part of New Jersey are you from?
I'm from Essex County.
Essex County.
Oh, yeah.
We've had a nice representation of
where
Jersey.
Where specifically yeah. Essex County? You know where Livingston is?
Yeah.
Livingston. So like right between West Orange, Caldwell, and the Hanovers.
That's my whole mom's side of the family from Edison.
Edison, that's
like Middlesex, right? Or
that's Middlesex. That's from Menlo Park Mall. Mm-hmm.
You know who's from Menlo Park or who lived in Menlo Park?
Who?
Thomas Edison. You know what he did? Created electricity in the light bulb.
Why does he have that all in West Orange then?
I don't know. The Menlo Park Observatory or the laboratories where he built all of the like gadgets for the light bulb and shit. I did one of my senior projects on it
that's beautiful.
Stevens Institute of Technology. Shout out the nerds.
That's fire.
So we have you here. We have a couple of New Jersey / New York artists coming in, but I feel like we're getting a lot more out of our New Jersey artists recently with Chris Patrick, man. Spitting some fire freestyles. Babyface represented.
Chris Patrick is crazy.
Babyface, you said you've collaborated with a lot.
Babyface, yo, he's awesome.
But nothing out
That's
yet.
That's my guy. We have something dropping definitely in March.
Cool, Bird. Cool. Hell
definitely yeah. In March.
Off the heels of an EP, 4, you just recently dropped.
Yeah, it's called 4. Like, I'm holding up my fingers for the people that can't see me.
For those all of our blind listeners who can't see our video promos, he had whatever the Braille equivalent of 4 is, he just put it up.
4 is so lit, like 4 is so lit because it's not like a pop. It's not like pop, but I feel like it has pop appeal.
I feel that too. You, the one song you had with the kid, Kill Bunk, who I remember you commented on my IG.
He's so nuts,
he's
bro.
He's fire from Georgia, right?
He's from Waycross.
Where is that? In Georgia?
That's in Georgia, yeah. He's not like from Atlanta, but he's going to be the biggest artist from Georgia.
You're stamping it right
that.
Now?
Yeah.
Speaking into existence. I love
it. I stand by Kill Bunk, bro. He's going to go crazy. He's amazing. He's only 16.
What the fuck? Damn. Really? Yeah. I looked at his page. He looked kind of old.
No.
He looks older. No, I'm going to say older. No. He just didn't look 16, but that's awesome. Shout out to Kill Bunk.
Yeah, bro. Shout out to Babyface, too. That's my guy. I think I heard about this from Babyface.
You did?
And I felt obliged to reach out because Babyface, like, he makes a move every day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He sets the bar for inspiration.
Well, he set a good bar here. You know, he gave us a great interview. We're trying to just build, you know, with the local guys that are here who we think are fire, and obviously you're fire.
I love it. Thank you.
We want to dive right into it, obviously. So let's talk about how long you've been grinding this music shit and where it all started with you.
Love it. Let's do it.
When was the first time you started freestyling or you started writing raps? When did this all like become conceived in your head? I imagine it's probably pretty early. I see you as like a poetry kid. Were you a poetry kid early on?
Not really.
So then how'd you get into it?
I got into it just by listening to rap music and then eventually just learning to freestyle.
What rappers were you listening to? What like time frame is this?
It was whatever my older sister would put me on to. She would put me on to like 50 Cent, Kanye, Eminem. Not as much Eminem, but more like Kanye. Mm-hmm. She was a big Kanye fan. Like College Dropout, that long ago.
Okay, so this is like early, mid-2000s.
It was that long ago. Like, it was College Dropout era. That's a minute ago, bro. We're going on 20 years of that album dropping.
It's crazy to think like that.
20 years since College Dropout.
That's so insane, bro. That album is so timeless.
It is timeless. I feel like I got into it, music, Kid Cudi, Man on the Moon. That's what really got me into it.
That's an amazing one.
Where my barometer of where it really engaged me. Ev's a big Lil Wayne guy.
Oh, yeah. But see, when I first started, it was really like, it was so much 50.
50, yeah.
50, even like Luda. I was a huge Luda guy when I was
really
young.
Luda
was
cool, yeah. My friend in high school put me on Luda when we were like 14. And I was like, yeah, this is fire.
I was I'm 25. Yeah, I was probably like 8 or 9, just listening, like, just Get Back and all that. Like,
I love
like
that district, song, bro.
All that
song
is amazing. Move, bitch, like all that shit.
Luda's video. Videos are very much like DaBaby's. I feel like they're very over the top. Back in the day, remember the Get Back video? He had like when he said, "I feel like a midget is swinging for my necklace." He actually had a midget painted silver.
He was before his time.
He was.
He just was such a different like vibe than what everyone else was doing at that time.
I totally agree with that.
Extravagant.
Shit. Yeah.
So you said this. Once you started listening to rap, you started freestyling. When did you develop? Obviously, we just saw your what's it called? Undeniable freestyle ability. Where did you develop that?
The undeniable freestyle ability?
The undeniable freestyle ability.
I would say that's an overtime. That's an overtime thing. That's not like a... I could do it. I woke up this morning and I could do it. I think that people need to see that.
See more freestyles or see more people with the
no, developing the
They need
freestyle.
To see the development. They need to see that it takes a lot of time.
So if we looked on your Instagram right now, like back, I don't know when you first started your page, because obviously you're big on social media with the freestyles. That's how I first came across you on TikTok.
That's beautiful.
Which we'll get into in a second. But do you think if we found like an early 20, like maybe 2017, 2016 freestyle video, it's going to be not as on par as what you would have right now?
You said 2016 specifically?
Well, I don't know. I don't know when you got into the, when you started first releasing music. I'm saying when you first got in the game, you said your freestyle ability wasn't as polished as it is now.
It was like okay. It wasn't bad.
Yeah.
But no. It wasn't like it was deniable. Like
it wasn't undeniable.
People would try to deny it, be like, eh. People still try to do that now, but I feel like people that do that now, they've seen maybe one video or two videos.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So you had some like natural ability to flow a little bit though.
Yeah. A lot of the inspiration for just freestyling came from 8 Mile.
Really?
Because 8 Mile
makes sense.
It's literally a visual display of the adrenaline rush that you get when you freestyle in front of a crowd.
Yeah, for sure.
That movie literally shows that.
So are you a big M guy as well? Or just more big, huge 8 Mile guy?
I'm both.
Okay.
I'm both. I grew up listening to Eminem. Like, out of the few rappers that really inspired me as a little kid, like Kanye, 50 Cent, Lupe Fiasco, Eminem, a couple others. But, like, Eminem was so up there. And, like, as a kid watching 8 Mile, it just made that much more of an impact.
Mm-hmm.
Because the reason why that movie is so popular is because people connect with the story.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
It's because, like, when you listen to the song Just Lose It, that's the song, right?
Lose Yourself. Just Lose It's the
song.
One with the Michael Jackson. Like the Michael Jackson where he lights himself on fire. Yeah.
Bro, when you listen to Lose Yourself and you watch the movie, like, you make the connection in your head. Like, the branding is just so on point.
Yeah.
To the point.
Have you ever been in that situation where you're, like, about to go out and you're staring in the mirror and then you just hurl because you're not ready or you're nervous?
Nah, it wasn't detail for detail the same thing.
No, yeah, yeah, I was just curious, like, you ever like been in a moment where you're just like, fuck, I don't know if I can do this, or if it's,
no,
it's,
I mean,
always just been natural.
I was in similar situations when it comes to freestyling where it would be right beforehand and I was nervous, like when I was younger. Me and Johnny Walker, do you know who Johnny Walker is?
I don't.
I know the
he's
drink.
Childhood, yeah,
Johnny Walker Black, Johnny Walker Blue. I'm a very fond of my whiskey, but
no, my childhood friend Johnny Walker,
shout out Johnny Walker. Is he make music as well?
Yes, he does. He raps.
Oh, all right.
He's very good. He's actually, in my opinion, he's one of the most talented artists from New Jersey.
There we go. I got to get put onto him then.
Yeah, he's amazing. So we were at a church. Don't ask why we were at the church because it's a long story. I'll put listeners to sleep with this story. We were at the church, right? Oh, what happened? We were in the bathroom, like, hyping each other up, getting ready because we signed ourselves up for the open mic.
At the church?
Yeah, there was an open mic downstairs. It was a Friday night, too. They were having, like, an event there. It was called 1307. It was called 1307. And we signed ourselves up, like, we called it the Ethan and John Rap Fantastic. And then it was him and me. It was, like, Johnny Walker and Ethan. I wasn't Ethan Ross.
You just Ethan. Ethan. Just Ethan straight.
Yeah, or we were RX5, like, those are duo.
Ooh, I like RX5. I kind of like the Ethan and John Rap Fantastic. That's a great fucking.
Okay, so let's go with that one. Ethan and John Rap Fantastic, right? So we signed ourselves up. I was nervous as hell. We were like, bro, this is like 8 Mile. This is like
in the church. 8 Mile with
the shelter.
One-on-one against the priest.
And I remember we were going hard, like rapping in the bathroom, preparing for it. And there were kids walking past us. We were all like 13, 14 at the time.
Oh, damn, it's early on.
Yeah, bro, we were like 14. And so kids were walking past us like, whoa, you guys are rappers? We're like, yeah. We got up on stage. That's the first time I remember really rapping on stage. It felt crazy. It felt so crazy.
Were people feeling it, like in the church?
I don't know.
But you felt it is what matters.
I was saying ridiculous things.
Any obscenities?
I said suggestive things, not curses. I'm the type of person, like, even when I couldn't curse, I would still say suggestive things, and I ended up getting myself in trouble. Which is funny, because now everyone that surrounds me knows me as, like, the good kid, because I'm straight edge and celibate. And, like,
celibate, wow, damn.
Yeah, because, like, I'm, like, I take good care of myself.
Okay.
And people know me like that. But growing up, I was the kid that everybody knew to get in trouble.
Just because you were, like, reckless with your mouth or saying crazy shit?
Yeah, pretty much.
Damn. Were you getting in trouble at school? Were you getting suspended in school or like just getting in trouble?
Middle school I was. By the time high school came around, I calmed down.
And then were you focused on music in high school?
Yeah, I was really focused on the music.
Oh, wow. Damn.
Focusing on the music actually took me out of trouble.
Yeah.
I feel like focusing on the music is what made me calm down because I didn't have a reason to act up anymore because it's like I could just act up with this.
Yeah, and that's your outlet.
Exactly. So like I'm just going to waste my time if I like just run my mouth in class and like fight with the teacher like I used to. Like that's like that would have been a waste of time.
Yeah.
Because now I have music. And I kinda want other kids to see that they don't really have to like cause ruckus in school to be cool. They could just find an outlet and be cool like that and all the other students will love them. They'll be popular off that.
Yeah.
They don't have to be popular off causing disruption in class.
I want to touch on the you said straight edge celibate thing. When did you decide to do this? I don't know if it was a conscious choice, and how is it, you think, affected your art? I don't know if you were making like music fucked up at all. Like, when you were drinking or previously, was it a conscious decision? Like, I got to clean my act up, or would you just want to like make sure your body was pure?
I don't know what it was, dude.
But it's going on 3 years, you said?
3 years of what specifically? Hold up.
I'm saying getting 3 years. When's the last time you had sex, and when's the last time you got intoxicated by any form of substance?
Oh, look what I got myself into with this interview. We're really going in on it. Yeah. Huh?
This isn't a music podcast. This is a.
We got to know the story.
Dr. Jetski is sex therapy. Yeah.
I mean, celibate rappers don't just come around every
now
and then. We
got to
know.
That's awesome.
We
got
to know. Hold up.
That makes you different.
My friend Love J San said he needs an hour long freestyle. You guys want to extend this an extra hour?
Hour long. Damn. We'll have to come back. Once we come back for the reoccurring guest episode, he'll have the entire episode to just freestyle, and we'll give you all the topics of the week and you can freestyle them.
I love this, so let's do it. Anyway, so let's continue with what we were talking about. Yes. Right, you want to know like what are my intentions with my habits?
Why are you celibate? Why do you not drink or do drugs?
So the reason why I don't engage in a lot of things is just because I want to it's hard to answer these things.
Is it like you want a clear mind? You don't want to be clouded by anything because you want to be so focused on your passion, your skill set?
I know myself.
Okay.
I know myself, and I know people that get distracted.
Okay.
I feel like when you're surrounded by a lot of people in your life that get distracted, you start to see what happens to them. Okay. You analyze what happens to them. You ever feel like you grew up and you watch people mess up?
Yeah.
Especially,
do you feel that way about people?
Especially now being like 25, like now you've like seen it.
Yeah.
Do you kind of like look back at people you grew up with and you're like, wow, like a lot of people made a lot of mistakes?
No doubt.
For sure.
No doubt.
I come from an area.
I've seen both sides. I've seen kids who made a lot of mistakes and then cleaned it up. And then I've seen a lot of kids who made mistakes and then are just like in jail. Like I've seen both of it.
I come from an area in Long Island where it's like, there's a lot of, it's very split and diverse, where there's like some, and a town could be comprised of like all different types of people, from minorities to like regular white people to rich white people to poor white people.
Mine's
I've seen a lot of kids like do really well in life, and then also a bunch of kids I went to school are like either some of them are dead or some of them are hooked on fucking opiates and shit. It's a big like epidemic back there. So I definitely, looking back now, see where some people went wrong.
Yeah.
Is that what kind of you saw and why you wanted to step away from things? Not to say that you were doing things to that extent, but you saw people making mistakes and kind of fucking up their life and you wanted to make sure you didn't do that?
I just need to stay focused. I need to stay focused. And like when you really want to stay focused is by any means. It's literally by any means. I'm getting a call from Zay Too Lit. He saved in my phone his baby girl with the blue heart.
I like that.
Yeah. Hello? Yo, are you here? I can't hear you, bro.
On the line, Zay Too Lit on speakerphone. Let's see how good these mics and bars really are.
Yeah, just pulled
up on second
floor. Pulled up on second floor, yeah. Walk in and then ask for Wayne. Somebody should be getting you too.
Colin's gonna get you.
Look out for Colin. He's wearing a black hoodie that says Lowering the Bar.
Shout out Lowering the Bar. He's the producer of that show on Barstool. So if anyone's listening and not privy to the show, make sure you go follow Lowering the Bar Instagram, Twitter,
fire,
YouTube, everything.
Oh yeah. It's Zay Too Lit.
All right, so we're gonna push your mic over here to the right, and we're gonna give you this mic.
Yes, sir. I'm excited for this one. I love this guy. That's my man.
Zay Too Lit has joined the program. Can you bump this mic?
Mm.
Oh, so you're gonna sit out right there.
Zay Too Lit has joined the program.
Oh, is that a chair over there?
Yeah, so you slide over here to me, and you're gonna be in that chair right there. You could probably help bridge the gap in some of these story questions we're asking Ethan to get a better look at why he we just asked him when he decided he wanted to abstain from clapping cheeks and hitting blunts.
You want to know what's really funny is that Zay Too Lit is in the same boat.
You guys both don't fuck or drink or do anything?
I'm just chilling.
Damn.
We would just be chilling.
Damn, some focus-ass dudes, bro.
I spend a lot of time around Zay Too Lit, too, because we're both very passionate-driven individuals.
I believe I follow Zay Too on the gram. I see your music, see your dancing videos. You go crazy with
it.
Respect to you.
One more time. Which water is yours? Which water is mine, my guy?
This one is mine. The one closer to me is mine.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, bet. This
positive,
is mine, then.
I'm positive that's yours, yes.
Bet. Thank you.
Anyways, okay, both of you guys are straight edge?
Yes.
Maybe. I get a little lit.
He gets a little lit.
I'm gonna be honest.
He's got one edge. You have the straight edge.
Yeah, I'm straight edge, but sometimes in the studio I take a shot of alcohol.
Okay.
Sometimes. All right.
Sometimes. Do you think that it alters your ability to record when you are under the influence or anything?
I just know I can't drive and I need to drive.
To the studio?
How am I going to get to the studio? Like, logically, it makes no sense. So
you could Uber.
I could, but like, if I drink, I need to make sure I'm going to be in the situation long enough for the alcohol to wear off. So let's say I go to the studio at 6. At 6:30, I take the shot. By the time 9:30 comes around, I should be good to go.
I guess so, one shot. I've never taken one shot ever, just yeah, one nah. shot.
I literally just take one shot, like I microdose it.
Microdose the alcohol, like it's acid.
Is that funny? Is that like a comedic thing?
It is kind of funny.
Just saying you microdose just alcohol
like,
is funny.
It's just funny because like me and Ev are like, and Colin as well, are just booze bags and we're like the exact opposite. Like, not that it's necessarily a bad thing.
Booze bags, that's crazy.
You having some trouble with this mic?
No, I think I figured it out now.
Okay.
I was like, I never took one shot in my
yeah,
life.
We just,
they call me the double vodka Don.
He's the double vodka Don.
So like how they say you can't just have one Oreo cookie? Is that how you feel about it?
Bitch, I'm having a whole sleeve.
Yeah, facts. You can't just have one Lay's chip.
No, I think one that's Lay's what they chip.
Say. Yeah, but Oreo cookies, one. It's the same thing with Oreo cookies. Like you can't just kill them all or they're not special anymore. Like you have to eat one at a time.
That's crazy.
That's how I view life now. That's how I take life. Like that's why I'm a healthier individual. Like literally, I have such bad acid reflux that literally I developed through bad eating habits.
Damn, too much hot sauce?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I literally used to almost drink it from the bottle. Like that's how obsessed wow. I was with hot sauce.
Yeah, that's no good. So I see. I guess you're. It's noble. I would say that you are cutting yourself off from things because you want to have more of a steady head and a clean body. I learned
my lesson from overdoing certain things.
What were you overdoing?
Everything. I was too invested in girls.
Okay.
I was too invested in just hanging out with people.
Yep.
To the point where if they wanted to smoke weed, yeah, I would do it.
Just because you were around there and like, fuck it, if they're doing it, I'm doing it.
Yeah, and I would convince myself that just being with certain people automatically made things productive because I was there. But like, I could be more productive while alone.
Yeah.
And you know, a lot of people around me want to do certain things, but now I'm more selective with who I'm around because like we talked about, after you grow up and you go through year after year, you grow up with these kids and you go to high school with these kids and you're around these people, you realize at one point you draw the line.
Mm-hmm.
You draw the line.
Where do you draw the line?
I think I drew the line like a year or two ago.
When you decided all this? With like the, or was this post deciding that you're going to go straight edge? Was there a specific moment that you can pinpoint? Like, this is what happened. This is why I did this. Not to harp on this moment so much, this one aspect so much.
You're saying, where can I pinpoint it starting at?
Yeah.
Like, so you're like epiphany moment.
You're challenging me right now. Zay, I want my people to see you. Hey, that's Zay Too Lit. Follow Zay Too Lit. Actually, follow you guys. Yo, this is Barstool.
But specifically, follow 808 and Smoke Breaks on Twitter.
Is that what it's called? Yeah,
808 and Smoke Breaks is the account. Yes, is the podcast.
I'm tagging it right now. It's 808.
At 808 Smoke Breaks. Like 808's in Heartbreak, but we stole Kanye's name. We stole some of his intellectual property. Bitch. We remixed it. Hit it with the re-rock.
I'm being honest with you, bro. This interview is getting a lot of positive reviews right now.
Oh, I'm glad. That. Shout out to
all my people.
Shout out the peoples. I want to. We're going to move divert away from the straight edge shit because I think we're harping on a little too much. But it is awesome that you're doing it. I want
to appreciate it, bro. I want people to know that even though I am straight edge, like I said, I don't want to like misrepresent it because sometimes I do take a shot of alcohol.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And also you seem like a person that you don't need necessarily that type of shit to get lit at a party environment. Like I saw a video of you freestyling at New Year's Eve. You look like you were the most hype person there. And I assume you probably weren't intoxicated.
No, I did not. I don't think I had any alcohol. That was a wedding too. That was a wedding.
Holy shit. How'd you get convinced? So that was all your family members, I assume.
Like who got married?
Not or just who was there? Like who saw you? Because I saw you start to freestyle in front of the wedding.
It was a bunch of people.
That's awesome.
It was a bunch of people. Yeah. I think just being calm is important. What do you think is Too Lit? You're a calm guy.
I'm a pretty calm guy. I mean,
pretty calm guy. He and I are pretty calm dudes.
When I go out, turn up.
No, sir. No, that's when he starts dancing.
Is Zay Too Lit?
Yeah, I think
you can't be Zay Too Lit and not get a little lit.
Yeah, I think I didn't want to cut you off, my guy. Okay, I'm saying me and Zay, I think we both had our issues with addiction, like in a light way.
Mm-hmm. No, I feel that.
Addiction comes from emptiness.
That's a fact.
Yeah, and so my goal is to not be empty anymore. Because one day, I'm cool to just talk to girls right now and just have friends who are girls, but eventually I want a relationship and I want it to work.
So that's why maybe the celibacy is coming into play.
It's not even that I have to be celibate. It's just I have to realize like that I need to be full. Not full of myself, but just full.
Your fucking balls are going to be full because you're just not fucking, bro. I don't know how you do that. Shouts out to you.
It's just been a minute, bro.
You feel heavier? Do you feel weighed down at all when you walk around? Like you have a little, you have a little MPH just taking off at top speed.
I feel like a superhero. I feel like I got a cape. I feel like I'm literally Superman, and like not even kryptonite could take me out.
Damn! Is you saying pussy is the kryptonite?
I think
at times it could be.
Any vice is kryptonite.
Good point. Good
any vice. So like I said, cookies. That's the great. I think sugar is harder to cut out. I was going on Twitter last night and I was talking about, I don't know if Zay or you saw it on Twitter, but I was like, yo, sugar is harder to cut out than anything.
Yeah. It's in everything. Yeah. It makes everything
fact.
Better.
It's a real fact.
It's so delicious, bro.
Well, I'm glad that you know, you're kind of making me want to be a little bit of a better person, cut out the booze. I don't know if I'm going to cut out the sex because I just love clapping cheeks. I know you're not going to cut out sex. His girlfriend's coming in town. He's going to be hitting this weekend. Yeah, there's no way he can stop.
Wow.
But I guess
I'm still a sexual person. Like, I love sex. If you want to talk about sex, we could probably go the rest of the interview.
I was like, don't get us started, bro.
Yeah, don't get us
so
started.
Don't get us started.
Like, I'm not horny.
Do you still watch porn?
No, I never watched porn for enjoyment.
What?
I never watched
for what?
The
real
then
punishment?
What punishment or
no,
research purposes?
I don't enjoy watching porn.
I think porn has fucked up my brain for sure.
It does that to everyone.
Oh, yeah.
It's not good. I shouldn't.
But
be.
You want to know what's even more messed up? You could call me a hypocrite. I would film and participate in porn before I watch it.
I've done both. So, like, it's
that's crazy, bro.
Not professionally shot. But,
I've literally discussed it. I've literally had discussions. I've discussed it. Like, it's been discussion. Ethan Ross pornography has been a discussion.
Really?
And, like, I offered to pause my celibacy in order to create.
Was there a bag behind it?
Gotta be. No, there would be a bag if it happened.
I like that.
But anyways, I'm saying, like, I think that you don't force things in life. So if success is coming your way, you don't block your success by chasing after vices.
Okay.
You know, so I'm not just going to be like, you know what? I'm going to get back into smoking weed today. No.
It makes sense. If it's working for you and you're not doing it and you're talking about success, then you shouldn't. And I want
to
piggyback off
that. That's what I'm saying.
That.
You attract what you attract.
Exactly.
So like, if I say, oh my God, I want dollar pizza so bad, and I say that 100 times, it's literally a dollar. I could literally walk out here. There's one down the block. But if I say, no, I don't want it, then it's not going to happen. Speaking into existence.
I guess that's true. I want to piggyback off of something you said. You said talking about success.
Plus, you gave me a free banana. Shout out you.
Shout out the banana. Shout out
the
me.
Free banana.
Shout out the free banana. I want to talk about your success on TikTok because
ooh.
It's a platform that we harp on a lot here. Whenever we have interviews, we always tell everyone to try to get their shit popping on TikTok.
Oh, man.
No one really always knows what that means. I don't know if I know really what it means, but you have 187,000 followers on TikTok. A lot of your TikTok content is premised of your epic, I'll call them epic freestyle videos through college.
So I wanted the Garden State Mall.
Yeah, college cafeterias, Garden State Mall. Tell us when you got, how you got started on TikTok and when it started popping for you.
So, in my eyes, I haven't made it on TikTok at all.
I'm still
a beginner.
A good following on it, though.
I would say I still get engagement. Hell yeah. Still get engagement. It was like a really fast pickup.
Were you on it early? I would imagine I've seen your shit. You posted a TikTok video on Instagram, like one of your TikToks on Instagram before I even had it on my phone.
Yeah. A good friend of mine, her name is Trippy Draws.
Shout out Trippy.
She's so lit, bro. She literally just draws trippy shit.
Who's more lit? Zay Too Lit or Trippy Draws?
Zay Too Lit is lit in his own way. Trippy Draws is lit in her own way.
That was a very media trained answer, but I'll accept it.
They're two completely unrelated, different people that have nothing to do with one another.
Okay.
I would not place them in competition because
over
it would make no sense.
Okay.
He said that's a media train.
I have a lit off.
Oh, man. Okay, so Trippy Draws, she draws hella cool shit, and she literally popped off that because her shit is just fire. I went to her house in PA, and she's like, Ethan, you got to make TikTok. I'm like, all right, fine. Because at first I was like everybody else. I was like, all right, I don't really want to make it, but I might still do it. Then she's like, no, do it. I posted my Wendy's freestyle. I went viral within like 2 hours.
How many views did it get? I'm sorry. I'm coughing. Burping.
It's all good. It's all good. It might be approaching 250,000 right now.
And that was the first one you put out? The first one that you put out that had success.
Yeah. Yeah, I posted it that day, and I posted it that day before I posted it on Instagram.
Okay.
But your platforms don't always cross over.
It's true, because a lot of people have like a lot of these TikTok influencers who are like 15 have a million followers, look at their IG and they got like 3,000.
Yeah, people don't notice that though. I've noticed it, but some people fail to notice it. Yeah, it's like that. Like, you could have a big SoundCloud audience and not the same engagement on Instagram. I see that.
Yeah,
all the time. I literally see people, I listen to people, I talk to people who have more engagement on SoundCloud than on Instagram.
It's crazy.
It's possible.
Engagement as far as you're saying plays, followers, all of it wrapped up?
Everything, all of it wrapped up. And like, I'm just thankful that I do have engagement on every platform. Like, I'm really thankful. And like, one of the reasons why I keep working so hard is because I know people see it and I know people acknowledge me. And no matter what, as long as I'm doing something, people will acknowledge it, you know?
So you started seeing your TikTok numbers go up when you started posting more Instagrams, I imagine. I'm sorry, more Instagram, more freestyle videos.
Yeah, those are
That's what really started cracking for you?
Yeah, those are really lit. I've done a few that are not that.
Yeah, I see some like skip based shit. I saw the one where you're stealing shit out of the
Target.
Out of the Target.
That Where'd one actually did go? Well.
Yeah,
it well. Where's my jacket?
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out Brianna. Shout out Brianna Lynn. She's amazing.
Did you see a, I know you said your platforms don't always cross over, but did you see an increase in like Spotify numbers from TikTok? Like, the more shit your shit got popping on TikTok, the more shit got popping on Spotify and other streaming
platforms? Were both simultaneous. I would say that people from TikTok definitely tuned into my Spotify.
Okay.
I don't know if it was like 10,000 people, but I would definitely say it was a lot of people.
Yeah, because I'm looking now. Your numbers, Katana, 367,000 plays.
Yeah, it's wild. If you go through the comments on some of my TikTok videos, you'll see what people say about my music.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Like, you'll see people being like, oh yeah, and like, this guy's music is actually better than this.
That's sick.
Like, there's someone who literally commented on a TikTok video saying, like, dude, you got to just stick to written music because that's your strength.
Well, obviously, the music you record in the studio is going to have more substance than a fucking TikTok freestyle.
You 100%, but yeah.
Respect the fact that you're walking around freestyling for fucking whatever, 60 seconds at a clip, which is obviously going to be longer than 60 seconds in the end of the video. But
yeah. Yeah, it's a shock value that drives it.
Yeah, for sure.
If you take the recorded music and you shoot a video to it that has the same level of shock value as a public freestyle, then it's a combination effect. And this is actually going to be the next phase of my plan.
Of the TikTok plan?
Well, this is my world's plan.
Wow, okay.
Worldwide plan. And honestly,
world takeover.
Yeah, I challenge other people to do it all the time. Like, I tell other rappers to go rap in public. Because initially, Johnny Walker, who, shout out him, shout out my bro.
Shout out Johnny Walker. And shout out Johnny Walker, Blue, Black, Red Label. If you're listening to this, also send us free whiskey.
Yeah, so Johnny Walker was, if not the first person, one of the first rappers to tell me that like the public thing was necessary, because he had the balls to go up to anybody. We would be at a show, or we'd be anywhere, like as kids, 15, mm-hmm. and he would just lead the way when we walked up to a group of older women, and he'd always want to talk to
them.
There's
always that one guy in the crew.
He's that one guy. He was not scared of a soul.
You need that guy, though.
Yeah, he was not scared of a soul.
He inspires everyone else.
Yeah.
And he bags the MILFs.
That's true.
I mean, he did. Yeah, all the girls like him.
See?
I love MILFs.
The girls still like him.
We need Johnny Walker on the podcast, I think, to tell some MILF stories.
I would love that.
And that's possible. Maybe link it up.
I just need to stand in the corner for that.
You can, absolutely. Be like,
I'm so proud right now.
but continue. You're going on with your world domination plan.
Yeah, basically, everything I do, I just want to have the same level of shock value as the public freestyles. Because when you go out in public and do things, you get rawness that literally you don't get anywhere else. Mm-hmm. And like I said, I try to tell other rappers, like all my rapper and artist friends, to go out in public and do shit. But it's very nerve-wracking and anxiety-inducing for most people, because there are people in public who hate to see it.
Yeah.
They hate to see it and they give you funny looks.
I think part of it's not even like like critiquing the quality of the rapping, whatever. It's more just like that secondhand embarrassment. Like, regardless of if it's good or not, I think people
just like putting yourself out there.
Because I think it takes a special type of person to have that in you, that like fire in your gut to go just do that.
By the way, rest in peace, Pop Smoke.
Yes, rest in peace, Pop Smoke. This is gonna come out. This is gonna be a week after, because we are recording today when Pop Smoke tragically was shot and killed in his home. So
really messed up.
Really fucked up. Really sad.
He was just coming out too.
Just coming out and coming out with a new sound out of New York. He was an innovator
for New York.
And he was now this whole Brooklyn drill wave is blown up, and he was the first one to really put it on the map. So it's super sad. 20
Which
years old.
Which is really crazy.
So crazy. It's fucked up, man.
Honestly.
RIP Pop Smoke, man.
Honestly, I knew he was young. I couldn't believe he was only 20. Yeah. And I listened to his music. Like, I'm a huge fan of his. I mean, I literally, the last like 2 weeks, I've been bumping his new album, like literally every day.
His song with Travis Scott, the Gotti song, was my favorite song out right now. It's so fucking hype. It's my gym song. It's terrible. Does that at all put things in perspective for you? Like, does that make you want to go harder? I feel like this last 2 years, I saw a tweet that was like, if you're a young kid listening to rap right now, every like year, for the last 3 years, someone has died. I mean, I was a huge Lil Peep fan. Lil Peep grew up around me, was friends with my cousin. Not grew up around me, grew up like in a couple towns over from me. It was huge when he died for me, huge when X died. Juice WRLD just crushed me. And now this, I feel like four of my favorite artists, not favorite, my people that I was super excited about and that were young guys that were going to change the game, I shouldn't say favorite, all passed away.
Yeah.
And it's like, holy shit, now I'm almost getting numb to it. It's like, fuck it, we just gotta accept there's no more music from this guy now. Like, not to say that's all he offered, but it's just crazy how we just keep getting these young talents just taken away from us.
Yeah.
Does it make you wanna at all put things in perspective, make you wanna go harder, make you think that you need to really get it while you're here?
Makes me wanna go harder, and it makes me wanna just tell these kids what's up. You have to tell these kids, because the kids are what we have, and like, these kids have role models that are dying.
Also,
role models all around them that are dying. That's why, like, I take the public speaking thing very serious.
Yeah.
You know, I take being a role model to kids very serious. Even though I curse in my music and I make vulgar music, sure. But as a person, like, I'm always going to take that motivational side of things serious, because we live in a world where you see what happens.
Yeah.
You see what happens in households. You see what happens in the industry. You know, you turn off the TV, it's happening. You turn on the TV, like, you can't escape what's going on. So, like, when I get to where I'm getting to, and I will get there.
I like that. Manifest that shit.
Yes, I will get there. I will still be a motivational speaker.
I love that.
I will still be a public speaker. I will still be there for the youth, for the high schools, for the middle schools, for the elementary schools, for the colleges, universities even.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
So you're giving me a lot of, I feel like, empowering, I want to say empowering motivation right now.
Thank you.
I fuck with that. And I see that's a lot of what's driving your music. I have one specific song that I don't know maybe what the basis of it is about. Mm-hmm. The Cocaine, the 5 a.m. song. That's where I found you. That's the first song that put me on to you.
Love it.
What is, you know, we're talking about being motivated. What motivated that song?
Chasing your dreams.
Was it? I think I've seen you say you never did cocaine. In the beginning of the song, you said you never done cocaine.
I will never do cocaine.
Good.
Ever in my life. I never want to. I never even wanted to. There was not a moment in my life where I actually wanted to do cocaine.
All right, good.
That was a metaphor.
That's a good, don't do coke, kids. It's a good message to put forward to the people. But what is the message behind that song? I knew, like, this of course, is like, this shit feels like cocaine. What is, are you talking about a girl there that feels like cocaine, or is it the rush?
The adrenaline of just actually doing something, like the rush of really getting it done, getting to it. Like, whether it's 5 a.m, 6 a.m, like, you've been up, but you know your dreams are coming true.
Yeah.
And I mean that in, like, a very real way. Like, imagine waking up at 5 a.m. for your shift, and then you don't go to bed again until it's like 4 a.m. the next day, and you're satisfied with it because you know that all the work that you're doing, all the work that you're putting in, it's making everything come into fruition.
Damn.
Yeah, it's just that fire.
Was that the first song that got, it really pushed you over the edge? Because I feel
like... Wait, I have a question. Was this your microphone before?
What do you mean, Mike?
When he came in, did we slide over?
I slid. This one was my mic. Yes, this was the one that was helping with the beat for the freestyle.
Got you. Okay. Anyway, what were you saying?
Was that the first song that showed a lot of success numbers wise and propelled everything else forward? Because it seems like, I feel like after that, everything else is going up as far as Spotify plays that you've dropped.
Everything was SoundCloud exclusive for like the first 8 or 9 months.
Which I feel like that's what everyone who in our age and our generation started making
music.
I
still drop SoundCloud exclusive.
But the money is just trash. You don't make any money from SoundCloud. It's trash. The pay is terrible. Really?
Mm-hmm.
I've gotten decent checks from Spotify and gotten half of the money from the same amount of plays for SoundCloud. I don't know if it's just my specific monetization, but last year I had way more plays on SoundCloud, and I got more money from Spotify.
That's how it goes. Like, there's a whole monetization process with SoundCloud where, like, you really have to own the rights to the song.
I think.
Well, for me at least.
Yeah.
You know, like, it has to be.
He's chomping on that banana. Shout out the good bananas out there. Shout out health. Shout out. Well, bro. No. You can keep going.
I keep eating it.
You can keep eating it. Yeah.
Eat the banana, bro.
Eat the banana. All right. We might have some ne'er-do-wells in the comments saying we can hear him chomping on it, but fuck them. You're all about health. You're putting some good potassium in your body.
Health is wealth, baby. Word. Health is wealth.
Health is definitely wealth, bro. What were we saying?
We were talking about the difference between Spotify and SoundCloud monetization.
Mm. So, like, you want to know about it?
No, I know about it. I mean, it helps pay my rent, so I know the difference between the shit. But not all of it. My numbers aren't my Spotify numbers are nowhere near as good as yours. But
stop it.
But
they're really good.
Yours are really good.
No, yours are real.
Mine are okay. I want to ask you about like playlisting. Do we have a label situation or anything like that? Are you with the Fashionably Early?
Shout out
Fashionably Early.
Fashionably Early. What's up?
I've been talking to Kyle. I think Kyle Miller. I want to get him here. Talk to him about the whole inception behind Fashionably Early. What's going on with that? So tell me how you got linked up with them. So they're like a distributor, I guess, right?
Babyface, yeah, he's the one.
Yep. Babyface with Fashionably Early. You guys got a good. I think and Chris Patrick has done some shit with them as well, right? Or has maybe a project or something. I don't know if he's under them completely, but that's awesome. So how have they helped your career getting like a team like that behind you? You think it's helped a lot?
It helped tremendously, bro. Promoting Sounds found me through Fashionably Early.
I wanted to ask you too. That's a huge YouTube. So, and for no one who knows, Promoting Sounds is a huge YouTube channel. They post new like hot up and coming music. I think they have over 1 million subscribers, right?
Hell yeah, they're creeping on 2 million.
Damn, that's crazy. But they break a lot of new artists, and I've seen was Cocaine on there.
Nah, they posted one of my original SoundCloud exclusives that like was a little slept on at first.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. And they gave it love.
So Fashionably Early, they kind of help you distribute your shit, do a little bit of PR work, I imagine, get your music out there heard and get your shit out to blogs and write-ups and stuff?
Yeah, they've gotten my numbers up tremendous just by like reposting because now like my sound gets a lot of love from the emo rap community.
I saw you on the Apple Music emo rap
Yeah, because my
that's huge.
A lot of my shit is emo rap. That's really what it is. And Promoting Sounds is really the hub for that. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of their artists are blowing up right now, and I'm gonna be one of the next ones to be. So
I love how emphatic Ethan is with speaking into existence. And I don't want that. I don't think it comes across as cocky, but for anyone who's like an artist or anybody who's like doing shit right now creatively or even not creatively,
bro,
it's a big thing speaking shit into existence.
You gotta really believe it.
The same way I fully believe in Babyface and Chris Patrick, I believe in myself too.
You have to.
Because
I was in, you know, it's gonna work.
100%.
My guy Zay Too Lit, he puts in all the hours. Zay Too Lit is coming up there with us. Like, we're all coming up together. Like, this is the time. New Jersey is really rising. And when I say New Jersey, obviously, I'm not talking about every single person. How much? There's like 9 million people in New Jersey, right?
It's the most densely populated state in the country.
Yeah. So I don't mean that literally, like, 9 million people are about to blow up with music at the same time. I mean, like, you know, there's like a select handful of artists that are making really good quality music.
Yeah. Awesome.
No
undeniable.
Doubt.
Undeniable music.
Who are some of your favorites from Jersey? Besides Chris Patrick, besides
Babyface,
besides the other guy who we talked about, Jack Daniels.
Johnny Walker.
Besides Johnny Walker. Give us two others that we need to.
Shout out Geno 5. You know Geno 5?
I feel like the name sounds familiar.
That man was an early role model to me too.
All right, shout out Geno 5. Mm-hmm. I gotta look into his shit.
When Ethan was still Ethan.
Before the Ross came in.
Right before the Ross came
in. Well, he was eating the big boss, Ross.
Geno 5 came along and was like, bro, get off your booty. And I was like,
bet.
I'm off my ass now. Thank you, Geno. Nah, Geno's dope as fuck. Like, one of my best songs, like one of my fan favorites, is like a song featuring him. It was on my EP Fever Dreams.
Okay.
It's called Blood on My Hands.
And give us one more. Give us one more guy in addition to Geno 5.
It's tough.
Or it could be a producer who you really fuck with.
Tom Jacob.
Shout out Tom Jacob.
Word. Shout out Zay Too Lit standing or sitting right next to me too.
Is Tom Jacob the might be an engineer. I see you're always in like a basement studio somewhere where it seems like you've been recording a lot of your shit. That's not a knock though. I record in my fucking room. So like is that Tom Jacob the guy? Is he in that studio or is he a different producer? You know what studio I'm talking about? Looks like there's wood beams everywhere.
And you're, I'm like, pretending like I don't.
I do my research, bro.
Where now Tom Jacob, he produced pretty much most of my biggest songs.
Awesome. Shout out to him.
Baby girl, she be shot like a tonna. Ramu, she might hit you like a sauna. Oh, I be scared to say I wanna. He produced that shit.
That's Katana.
And
correct?
Gave you love. Gave you love. Gave you love. Gave you love. It ain't enough. I feel like that commercial. You know that commercial says the greatest hits. You can buy this CD with all the greatest hits of the late 2010s.
Oh, like a holiday infomercial. It's like a U-log in the back. It's all the holiday hits coming down.
You got Ethan Ross's songs from 2019. And it's like Katana.
With a bow tie and a black tux.
Yeah.
I like that.
Nah, with me, it'd be like all black everything.
All black everything, murder. Yes, you are. Sir. You are in all black everything besides the J's.
Besides the J's, but you know, I even got the black tank top underneath the black collared shirt. You know,
look like an art student.
For when I take it off for the ladies, because low key I lied about being celibate.
you do low key look like you might teach an art class at a state college in your free time, and afterwards you just like they throw the fucking easel on the wall and just start rapping for the students. You can do that.
Yo, just become a rapper after class.
After class, yeah.
I know a teacher who raps.
Is he fire? No.
Yeah.
Don't bless his name if you don't want to, but plug his SoundCloud, Spotify if he puts it out there.
Ooh, the reason why I said yeah is because he's more like a singer than a rapper. Okay. He's very melodic.
I like that.
His name is Michael Waves.
Michael, that's a good name too.
Michael Waves.
Mikey Waves.
His music, he makes like very like vibey music. Mm-hmm. It's like vibe music.
Wavy music.
Shout out Michael Waves. He's lit. I'm going to have a song with him.
Speaking of waves, what wavelength, what like path are you looking to go down for the rest of 2020? Are we doing another project? Are we going to do singles? Are we going to see more videos? Let me know what the people have in store from Ethan Ross.
Mm-hmm. I got something big with Zay Too Lit dropping next month.
Can we tease that or just we're going to go with something? Is it a project? Is it a video? What is it?
I don't know how to tease it properly. How do I tease things? Do I like poke it?
You can poke it.
Just give it a little poke.
Poke it with some words.
Right in the stomach.
Yo, you don't poke the bear, you poke the eagle bear. Shout out my eagle bears. You know what the eagle bears are, right?
Is that like an eagle scout?
I have no idea.
This is my fan base. My fan base.
Is the eagle bears?
My fan base, bro.
Like believers?
Oh, so instead of believers, you have
eagle bears.
Eagle bear. I'm an eagle bear.
Are
you an eagle bear?
I'm an eagle bear for sure. I just didn't know.
I didn't know that
eagle bears existed.
I like that, huh? I'm an eagle bear.
Yeah, you should be an eagle bear.
Like E-A-G-L-E?
Eagle like the birds.
Yeah, eagle bear.
E-A-G-L-E-B-A.
Eagle bear. I'm an eagle bear, like eagle like with the beak.
But it has a bear's body and wings?
Or the other way around.
Genetically probably impossible, but we're going to go with it. Because, you know.
Why is it eagle bear?
Huh?
Why is it eagle bear?
It's eagle bear because you have the you have the flight of the eagle and the strength of the bear.
Eagles are also very strong, though. Well, I've seen eagles throw goats
eagles
off
are
cliffs.
Smart.
Eagles are brilliant, but I'm saying why bears are there is because bears just are the most literal representation of an animal holding their ground.
All right.
I feel like if you see a bear, you're like, wow, that bear is, you just can't mess with it. Like, what are you going to do? Let's say a bear is blocking the hallway. How are you going to make the bear move?
They eat fish though.
It depends what kind of bear it is.
It's good for you. Fish is so good for you.
Do you know how to combat an attack from a brown bear? Brown bear and black bear, or grizzly bear and black bear.
I need this for my hike. Tell me.
Yeah, okay, sprawl out as far as you can and let him chop anywhere. You're good.
If it's a brown bear or a grizzly bear, you're supposed to. Grizzly bear is supposed to climb a tree because they can't climb trees. Black bear, you just play dead. Black bears are very good at climbing trees. So if you see a black bear chasing you, you have to play dead because if you try to climb a tree, it's going to get up there.
You better not get them mixed up.
Trust me, I know.
We used to be
hunting bears back in the day.
You climb the tree around a black bear?
You do not climb the tree around a black bear.
I'm saying, yeah, but you get them messed up, you're fucked.
Yeah, but you can just play dead. Black bears won't eat you if you're dead.
What about a grizzly bear eat you if you play dead?
Yeah, they're known. They're big animals. They're known to kind of be like vultures.
Necrophiliacs?
Bears will also fuck you.
Really?
A grizzly bear will also fuck you.
They'll kill you and then fuck your dead body?
They'll fuck your dead body. You didn't watch the Revenant?
Nah.
Leo got fucked by a bear.
No,
he didn't.
Yeah, he did.
I don't watch movies.
Yes, he did. He fucked the bear.
He
let the bear inside him and then he stabbed the bear and that's how he killed him.
He let a bear penetrate
him. Are you related to Relic Rhymes?
Yes, he is Relic Rhymes. Did you know that?
You look like this rapper I know. This rapper I know, Relic Rhymes. Shout out Relic Rhymes, by the way.
Shout out Relic Rhymes.
He has the same name as me. His name is Ethan as well. You look so much like him. You look like him, but just with a beard.
We all look kind of like each other. I'm a strawberry blonde. You're a strawberry blonde. You're a ginger. You're a little red haired guy.
Are you related to Ethan Ross?
Are we cousins?
Maybe.
I think we might be, dude. It's crazy. I want to get back to what I said though. So what can
Zay Too Lit and I are twin brothers?
We're talking about eagle bears, and because you got to talk about your fan base. But what you were saying, you and Zay Too Lit have something on the way for us to look out for. What is that?
It's called Patience.
And is it project, video, single?
It's a single.
Single with the video. Like, we're doing it real smart. We're dropping the single with the video, right?
That's smart. I like that.
Love that. And Babyface is on the song, too.
Ooh, let's go. Shout out. 808 Smoke Breaks alum, young Babyface.
Babyface is on it, yeah. And go.
Ghost Rule from Lowland.
He's on that too.
So. Yeah.
I don't know if I know Ghost Rule, but he
Ghost Rule
like,
fire.
He sounds like he's got some fire.
He's
on.
Fire, yeah. So we got that Zaytoo lit. We're probably going to compile other stuff we have into a little EP and just drop that like probably over the course of the next month and a half. I got a song on the way with Tom collaborative with Zaytoo lit on the beat.
I like that. Again, I've
beat collaborations. Like yeah, beat collaborations really run it the fuck up. They okay. always yeah. do. Like on my EP, Tidal Waves, it was a collaboration between Cash Paradox, who's like from another state, and then Tom, and they killed the beat. Now it's getting a video directed by Justin LA.
Justin, shout out Justin LA. I think Chris Patrick was saying he recorded some of his video, shot some of his videos. Mm-hmm. So shout
yeah,
him out.
Yeah, he works with the whole. He works with the whole wave. Like
I want to make sure anyone's listening to this who's a creator or so or tapped in at all to a music scene or any type of scene. Any of these names you're dropping, or if you fuck with people, feel free to you know slide into some DMs if you're an artist. You might have to pay for some beats or something like that, but it's a good way to network.
You said pay for features?
If you're asking, hey, I'm saying hit it up like a producer, one of these guys will be named. Because I always try to tell people like my buddies, Beats by Saj and Arco Snow, I always name drop them, and they're always looking to sell some beats. So hit them up if you need some beats. Not
or
necessarily
Zay
you,
too lit.
I'm saying everybody.
Or Zaytoo lit.
Or Zaytoo lit.
I just worked with Arco Snow a few weeks ago.
You did? Arco's my boy.
Yeah.
That's Denzel.
Yeah, we had him on the podcast. Yeah, that's
I
my
love
dude.
Denzel. We butt heads all the time, but that's my brother. That's my Nigerian brother. I know we touched this is good audio crunching up the chips.
It's like an ASMR.
It's like can you want to do it closer to the mic?
It's really hot.
He's crunching crunching the mic. Oh.
This right. shit gonna end my celibacy tonight.
Yo, before we get you out of here, I know we were talking about getting you on a beat again, but maybe change it up a little bit. If we could throw
on
some topics
again,
at you.
Beating them cheeks.
Can we have you beat the cheeks of the beat up and throw some topics to you while you rap for this outro?
Let's do it.
All right, so before the outro, thank you so much, Ethan Russ, for coming through. You're definitely a character. Fire-ass music. Tell people where to find you before we send you out on this freestyle.
My Instagram is @TheRealEthanRoss. My Spotify and Apple Music and SoundCloud, it's super easy. It's literally just Ethan Ross. So ETHAN space ROSS. You can find me so easily. It's literally a joke how easy it is to find me. My Twitter, I forgot my Twitter handle, but I'm on that every day. I'm pretty sure it's like @EthanRoss5am.
Okay.
Follow my Instagram just for all my updates @TheRealEthanRoss. And obviously, if you have TikTok, I'm assuming this is an older audience, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So considering that you guys are older, like the fact that you might use TikTok, here it is. It's @EthanRoss with red hair. So that's Ethan Ross with red hair. Don't forget the with red hair, and please no underscores because it's literally just one word.
Okay, don't forget the Ethan Ross with the red hair. We're gonna throw a beat on right now. I'm gonna give you three topics that I want you to incorporate.
One more thing. Please subscribe to my YouTube. I have mukbangs up there.
Mukbangs.
If anyone just search Ethan Ross. Literally just search Ethan Ross.
All right. So then I'm going to have my first. Can I give you three topics? And then once you hit those three topics, Ev's going to give you three topics.
You can give me as many topics as you
want. And then maybe Colin
will
give you three topics. So I'm going to give you three off the bat. When you hit them,
can we do five fingers of death?
Five different beats. I think we're going to do one beat just for the sake of time because we got to keep the whole podcast to an hour.
You
can, and we're like 40
you can
right
literally
now.
Switch.
Like. All right. So maybe we'll switch the beats up a little bit, but my first three topics are going to be mukbangs,
okay,
platypus,
okay,
and poker.
Platypi.
You ready? You can start over however you want.
Let's do it. Yeah. 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 I'm going to tell you if I need to beat Risen. Ooh. You'll have all the footage after this?
Yes.
Make the beat loud. Make the beat. Yeah, yeah, that's good. Platypi, Ethan Ross has said I have to die. Killing they fathers is matricide. I am their father, ha ha ha. Came rap big in the house. Come back in and you know that I put my dick in the mouth. Ethan Ross, don't, they don't even know what I'm about. Coming back in with the gas, they get doused. Every time they look like a mouse. Coming back in and a fucking old bitch and I take off a blouse. I put my dick in the mouth, kicking you right off the couch and putting my foot in. Every time that I do this, I be on the beat and these people be like, oh my goodness. Oh my God, it's Ethan Ross and I've been a boss. I don't wear Lacoste. So I'm more like Polo, more like Han, cause I be solo. Yeah, I be riding my dolo, and they don't know that it's so froze like snow globe, and I cold flow like Steve Austin. Fuck that, no, I go to Austin, that's Texas. Got a bitch named Alexis, gotta hit her with text message. Who am I having sex with? A lot of your bitches coming back in, and you minding your business. Coming back in, and I feel like it's an icicle, so damn cold. Ethan Ross in a spit where they don't know. What's the topic that you gave me?
Mukbangs.
Got mukbang, and you know that a lot of girls do bang on me, but you know that I really gotta do this, and I roam with the army. It's a mukbang, cause it be eating on camera. Ethan Ross, yeah, you know that. that I'm a damager. Don't have a manager. Had to be so low on my own though. Poker. Every time I'm a spot that I don't know. Poker face and I poke though with a card. You know that I really pull your card. Really gonna be hanging on the boulevard. Yeah, got a card like it's poker. I'm not a smoker. Just kidding. Sometimes I like the gas. Every time in a pup pup pass.
Provolone cheese.
Buffalo. What?
Provolone.
I thought he said buffalo. Yeah. Hey, I thought that he said the buffalo cheese. Ethan Ross, I'm like, oh no, please. I just murder all these MCs. I'm so cold. Freeze. Provolone and it's like Swiss. Every time that I might just take that fucking light switch and I be like, good night, bitch. And I turn it off. Turn it off and I don't want to talk and I just want to make money. Ethan Ross and I'm just like a dumb. You smell like cheese. You smell so funny.
Pubic hair.
Pubic hair. Yeah, my pubic hair is fucking red. Ethan Ross, you know I always get the fucking head and you know I'm underfed. Gotta eat because I'm always hungry. Ethan Ross gonna go straight dummy. Pubic hair. Provolone and you know that I be like home alone like Macaulay Culkin. You know that I'm always soaking because I'm so sad. Just kidding, I'm mad happy. Shout out my girl Rico Nasty, she's so good. I want to marry her and be her husband. Ethan Ross and I'm like, ooh, 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 I need a budget of a million. I'm killing, I'm always filling the building. You know I'm chilling, I'm getting a couple.
The goddamn Jets.
The Jets. I don't know about the Mets. I don't know about sports. If I knew about sports, I forget. But I'm at Athletic. You know that it's so damn pathetic. I'm talking my shit, they don't get it. The people wanna know where I'm headed. I'm talking about Mets, yeah, I got a baseball bat. Call your girl and they call back. Like Ethan, where your face all at? In her pussy, and I eat that. Oh wait, really gotta beat that. Ethan Ross, no, I never do it, relax. Oh, 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 you better go ease back.
Take my message, delete
that. Ellen DeGeneres, gotta put me right on the show. Ethan Ross, no, I got a lot of flows. Damn, I feel like a monster, whoa. You better back up, back up. Shout out to Ellen. Yeah, yeah, my future, I'm telling. You know that I feel like Magellan. And why am I screaming and yelling? I gotta take it down just a minute. Shout out DeGeneres. Ethan Ross, you know that I'm feeling so
female
generous.
Condoms.
Female condoms. Ethan Ross, yeah, I feel so awesome. Right. Woo. In the office, you know I'm an offer. Man, Ethan Ross with a female condom. We not talking, gotta put it all on. Ethan Ross, yeah, you know that I'm like a magic wand. And I put the condom on, you know that it's so awesome. Make an awesome song. Shout out my man named John. Ay, know what to pass a baton. Ay, need a female condom. She gotta put it on so she keep clean. Ethan Ross, it's like creatine. I'm so big, need quarantine. Cause I'm sick as fuck with that. Woo. Illness. Just kidding, I'm not ill, I'm healthy. Ethan Ross, what the fuck you gonna tell me? Shout out to my girl, her name is Kelsey. Wait, we not friends no more, but she really, 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 really fucking cool though. Remember, we were in school though.
That was amazing. Thank you so much, you. Ethan Ross. Crazy. Fucking murdered it. Freestyle legend. Oh, thank my you. God. Setting the bar high. Thank you guys for tuning in. This was 808s and Smoke Breaks. We're going to be coming at you with the segments. Thank you again for Ethan Ross. Make sure you check out his music. Check out his Spotify, his everything. We will be back in a break. Yeah. After a break.
All right. Well, shout out to Ethan Ross for coming through. Ultimate freestyler.
Just went fucking bananas.
We need to set him and Chris Berserk. Patrick toe to toe. Not even toe to toe. But I was,
no, we're going to get that cypher.
Get that cypher. Every time we've.
The cypher's coming.
Cypher's coming.
That's a big thing, though. That'll take a little bit.
Yeah.
The cypher's coming. Little Jersey, little Babyface, Chris Patrick,
some
Ethan
Long
Ross.
Some Long Island guys. We'll have Huss come
have
through.
Have Huss come through.
It's something I've been trying to do, like. We've both been trying to stress to like any artist who comes through because we're having a lot more guests. As you guys have seen, a lot more artists. We're going to have a really good interview with someone special next week as well. We're trying to get a little backlog and bring you guys more guests and also maybe do something cool like a cipher with the artist we did. But it's time to move on to the fucking segmentations.
Yeah.
So we just played before the interview and everything, before we got started, we were playing this video of Doja Cat on IG Live. Kind of freaking out. Seemingly looked
kind
like
of freaking out.
Yeah, she was bugging.
She
out.
Literally was no a bug out.
She
looks like she is like on like just like bugging on cocaine.
It's kind
that
of
is the
like,
drug that would seem like she was giving symptoms that she may or may not have indulged in.
Definitely seemed like she was on cocaine a little bit. She was on
titties hanging.
Titties hanging out. She even mentioned that her titties were out.
Oh, they sure were.
And she was on IG Live basically talking to Russ, saying that she wanted to fuck him, but he needs to shut the fuck up, that people don't care, that he
produces
his own music.
It took her about 3 minutes to say, to basically the whole point of this entire video.
If you want to see her rant, go on to 808 Smoke Breaks Twitter, by the way.
Hit the Twitter, just so you know what we're talking about. Hit our Twitter, hit our Instagram. Video's up there right now when you're listening. The entire context of the video could basically be summed up into one sentence. It was to tell Russ, I want to fuck you, but shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up. And she called him Russell. She said, Russell.
He goes, Russell.
Listen, Russell.
And then she just starts geeking out.
She just geeked out, laid out on the floor. I like, people were saying that she was on coke. I kind of think that she's just a crazy, crazy chick.
If I mean, if she's 1,000% sober,
yeah,
and acting in that manner.
No, I think she came out and admitted that she made another video, said she was drunk as shit or super hungover.
Something.
But hungover? No coke. She said no coke. I think she was drunk.
Well, I mean, I'm not gonna buy her at face value.
Why?
You just completely believe that she wasn't on coke?
I don't know.
She said she wasn't.
I don't know. I've seen other videos of her though that's sober on her IG live, just being weird as fuck, like just doing weird shit, like making.
I mean, if she's
weird, gross
if
faces.
She's, I don't care.
There's hot girls that are really, really weird.
Well, no, I mean, there's just people that are weird.
Yeah,
but she
I think sometimes
like,
we don't think the hot girls can be weird.
She's on some other shit.
Yeah, she's on some other shit.
She's just giggling to herself.
Mm-hmm.
She had to be drunk.
Definitely drunk. I could see a little.
She's
also touching her nose and going a lot. And she was like,
that's
I have
I'm
boogers
saying.
In my nose. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
Like, lady, this ain't my first time around a set of keys. Come on.
She did.
Car keys.
Doja Cat indulged in a little bit of uppers.
I think she did too.
Maybe some drinking, a couple bumps, a couple of those.
Yeah. So that's who we're pouring one out from for this one, essentially.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a great look. Not a great look to be on IG. Just say, what did she say? She was like, I will braid that half a day.
I will braid your half a days. But shut the fuck up. No one cares. You produce your music. It's filling one up. I guess that would be the opposite of pouring one out for Russ. Big W.
Yeah.
Big W. Someone who's used to, I wouldn't say catching L's. Like, his music does great. He makes great music. Russ is a great artist. Does really well album wise. He just gets shit on social media. But I feel like that's just been slowing down.
Basically because he's just against Xanax and like, lean and shit, and then now people are like.
Sometimes he has some ill-timed statements. He sometimes uses people's or has been accused of using people's like misfortune as a platform, but using that opportunity to like
to kind of be like, "I told you so."
I told you so, instead of letting people mourn.
No, it's fair.
He does speak some wisdom sometimes.
It's fair,
but a lot
I think
times,
it's
though.
Fair, but it's also kind of like when you. I think you have to show that restraint and just know the way to like approach it.
Yeah.
But I do like, it's not like, cause it's just not a good look to like really losing like a life and being like, I told you so. Like, all you dumb motherfuckers. Like, I'm not saying
doing fucking. Like, yeah. Like someone when Lil Peep died, he's like, oh, you like this is why you kids can't be like fucking around with pills, all this shit.
But at the same time, it's like, that is like true though.
Yeah.
Like I think there's he just needs to go about it maybe a little less like blatant, but I think there's no way to kind of like say it without catching heat.
I agree.
It's just like, it's just what, it's just what
you
it
just,
is.
You kind of just gotta let shit take some time.
You gotta let other people be like, damn, like Russ was right. Yeah. But I get where he's coming from, wanting to be like, yo, like, this is why I'm preaching this shit, because there's people out here, like, talented dudes, like, good people that are literally, like, dying from this shit. So there is part of me that, like, I completely understand it, because I think he's coming from, like, a good place.
I never thought he wouldn't come from, like, a good place. It just, you know, there's something about people who are, like, excessive winners or overachievers. Sometimes they want to let you know. I feel like he's kind of like that.
Yeah.
And he probably feels like he has an obligation to, but I don't know. What are you smiling about?
No, I just text, my boy just sent me a text.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you hit something, a big bet or something.
No, I got smoked last night.
Ugh, that's rough.
Fucking smoked.
So I think in overall, W for Russ, poor one out for Doja Cat. I loved the fact that she acknowledged her titties, though. I like that she was like, my titties are all.
I mean, yeah, they're out.
I look like a prostitute.
Oh yeah, they're out. Yeah, you do look a little prostitute-y.
A little tootie.
I was going to say a little tootie.
A little prosty.
I like Tootie better.
Shout out Doja Cat though. She's fire, and I like that she made a song about being a cow. That made no sense, and she went viral off of it.
She's kind of good looking.
She's a good looking girl.
Yeah, she is.
She's like a light skinned Latina, something got like that going on there.
Yeah, she's a little caramel. She's a little caramel
she's
thing.
She's a caramel.
She thickums.
She thickums?
Yep, thickums.
Thickums like a snickums?
Yep, thickums like CCUMMS.
I thought you were saying thick, like thickums like CC Sabathia. That's what you're going to say.
No.
I was like, correct.
Pause.
Not wrong.
Pause. Should we shout out CC though, the goat.
Yeah.
Fat fuck.
Oh, yeah. What a jerk.
All right. Fucking bitter ass Colin.
Fat
never
fuck.
Won anything in his life.
Fat fuck.
He's not even that fat. I think he got lap band surgery.
No, he's better when he's fat. When he got skinny, he started getting shelled.
Did I just make that up? He definitely didn't get lap band surgery, right?
No.
That was Rex Ryan.
No, he got skinny. He started getting shelled.
And he's like, oh, fuck it. Let's go to.
He put some weight back on. And he started pitching.
He did the steakhouse.
Yeah,
and, like and he also just learned to pitch without getting older and like losing his velocity. He learned to like be more of like a gamer.
See, Bartolo Colon was big, sexy. You guys just had a fat fuck.
I mean, no, we have champion.
Bartolo Colon's
you have guy who hit a home run once.
The greatest.
CeCe's hit home runs too, but yeah, that's he's like a legit sandbox. Athlete. Dude, I love Bartolo Colon. You will not hear me like,
yeah, you just gotta respect units. What the fuck?
No, I love Bartolo Colon, but I'm saying you can't come out like CeCe. I'm gonna defend CeCe. CeCe's also CeCe's my unit king.
That's noble.
CeCe's my guy. I'll ride through the gates of hell for CeCe Sabathia. I like Bartolo Colon. I love CeCe Sabathia.
I hate when people ride through the gates of hell. You wouldn't break into a house if CeCe Sabathia told you to.
Maybe.
No, see, they don't say you'll ride through the gates of hell.
I would, though.
I wouldn't.
I'll ride for him.
Okay, you'll support him on the internet when other people talk shit about him.
I'll ride for CeCe.
You'll talk shit on the internet.
If he asked me to be in a biker gang with him, I would. I'd accept his invitation.
All right. I feel like a biker gang.
I think that's fair.
He'd be in like a Wild Hogs biker gang, though. I'm saying, like, would you commit a crime for an athlete?
Well, Wild Hogs was dope. That's such an underrated movie.
It is an underrated. It's a lot of shit.
When he eats a stick of butter, it bugs me out. Gives me the creeps.
Should we do slaps of the week?
Yeah, let's do it.
You guys go first because I'm going to play mine.
Have I already done my piece on someone you loved?
No.
Okay, I've been saving this for a little bit.
What does your piece mean? You're going to sing it?
No, I have some thoughts on it. The song Someone You Loved by Lewis Capaldi.
Oh, yo, that dude does not look like how I thought he would.
So I want to say
beautiful
one thing.
Voice, ugly man.
I want to say one thing. So I had probably heard this. I definitely heard it like a bunch before this.
Yeah.
But I think it was played around me a few times in a row where I was actually at Subway with Marty getting lunch and it was on in the subway. And I just had this like epiphany moment that I was like, damn, like this song is phenomenal.
Phenomenal.
And then
moving, very
then
beautiful.
I'm in an Uber the next day. On the like going to the path, and it was on in the car, so I added it to my Apple Music. And that morning before work, I'd gotten pretty high, like higher than I usually get. And I was sitting, I swear to God, I played it on repeat. I was sitting on the path train, high, listening to Someone You Loved on repeat, and I started to cry. I wept on the PATH train.
Should I play it?
I swear to God, on my mother's life, I had real grown man tears rolling down my face.
I would love
someone
to see
you,
that.
While someone you loved played through my headphones over and over and over again. What a beautiful song.
I'm going on during this time. I fear there's no
save you.
This all or nothing really got away, driving me crazy. I need somebody to hear, somebody to know, somebody to have, somebody to hold. It's easy to say, but it's never the same. I guess I kinda like the way you numbed all the pain. Now the day bleeds into nightfall, and you know it hits. You get me through it all. I let my gut down, and then you pull the rug. I was getting kinda used to being someone you love.
Like, those are beautiful lyrics.
That was amazing.
I know.
Like, he is incredible.
Like a lightning bolt just struck.
Right? Like, you really get invigorated. Like,
yo, I literally, if you have a special someone in your life, yeah. I literally was sitting there thinking about my parents, like my girlfriend, my best friends. I was like, my one best friend getting married. All like, I was literally started thinking of like every like person that mattered at all in my life.
Yeah, that's like a wedding video song, like in the background. You know what I mean? Where it's like the whole day and it's just that in the background.
But then
I immediately my first thoughts in my mind, I was like, damn, this is gonna be like my wedding song. But then I also thought, I was like, it's literally about finding the person you loved and then the ripping the carpet out from
yeah.
under you.
Yeah, it is about
so it's literally about heartbreak. So I was like, yeah, that can't be it. But what a beautiful song.
Sad songs are really great to listen to sometimes. Like in with your boys, like listen to some fucking sad songs with your boys. Some dude, fucking Sarah McLachlan.
The best is when like it's so good that you just start it over three quarters through. Dude, you're like, you don't even let it get to the end. You're like, let me hear it again.
People throw numbers out. I swear to God, I listened to this song. It just was on a loop. Like when it stopped, it would just start over.
That first minute is so powerful.
I swear to God, I listened to it 40 times in a row. I listened to it for like over 2 hours.
Want to give it one more rip at the beginning?
Please.
Okay.
That's like, I forget what movie it's from. I think it's an Adam Sandler movie, but like something sad's happening.
Keep going. And they just, it's like the same, but he like switches it up.
They just like all start calling their parents. Oh, it's Big Daddy. Yeah, they're like, Dad, after the court date, like, I love you. I feel like you'd be doing that listening to this song.
Oh my God, dude. I'm telling you, I was sitting on the PATH train just crying. This is a light song. Nothing really got away, driving me crazy.
I need somebody to hear. I need a girl out to this song. Somebody
to hug. Colin, it's a beautiful moment. I'm not eating box. It's the same, but it's never the same. I guess I kinda like the way you numbed all the pain. Now the day bleeds into nightfall, and you're not here to get me through it all. I let my guard down, and then you pulled the rug. I was getting kinda used to being someone you love. I'm going under in this time. I fear there's no one to touch you. He feels alone. This all or nothing way of loving, go be sleeping without you. Still feeling
beautiful.
Still feeling alone.
Jet ski at the gym. Listen to this.
Somebody to hear, somebody to have, just to know how it feels. It's easy to say, but it's never the same. I guess I kinda like the way you numbed all escape. Now the day bleeds into nightfall, and you're not here to get me through it all. I let my guard down, and then you pull the rug. I was getting kinda used to being someone you loved.
Hit that high note.
My eyes, sometimes I fall into.
Everyone listening right now is like, what the fuck? Go back to the podcast.
They're with us right now. They're with us.
So now the day bleeds into nightfall. Yeah, you know he's to get me through it all. I let my guard down, and then you pull the rug. I was getting kinda used to being someone you love, but now the day bleeds into nightfall. Yeah, you know he's to get me through it all. I was getting kind of used to being someone you loved.
Like, what a beautiful tune.
They kind of, with
like,
you.
No, and the reason I was so upset, it was right after the fact that this song did not win Song of the Grammy for Song of the Year is a fucking outrage.
It's beautiful.
No shot against Billie Eilish. But put this song next to Bad Guy side by side and tell me which song is better. Like, that is a better song. That is a great song. You cannot tell me.
It's just powerful.
You cannot tell me there was a better song made in 2019 than that song.
Probably because the guy's fucking ugly.
I don't care what he looks like.
When I first saw the music video, I was like, wait, he sings this?
I don't care if he wrote that. He is in touch with himself and the gods.
This is going to sound really mean. I thought he was like disabled when I first saw
him. He's like an Ed Sheeran type. Like, he's just ugly.
Ed Sheeran looks ugly, like fucking Robert Pattinson.
He's ugly, but just has the voice of an angel.
Yeah, compare Ed Sheeran to Robert Pattinson?
Saying, like, if he looks like Ed Sheeran, then Ed Sheeran looks like Robert Pattinson.
I was like, bad comparison, man.
And this man, his range.
Amazing.
Those high notes and then pulled the rug. On that, like, hitting that like deep. I was like, yo, this guy is unbelievable. Lewis Capaldi.
Shout out Lewis Capaldi.
My Slap of the Week, Someone You Loved by Lewis Capaldi.
If anyone listened to that song fully through, please tweet us because I would appreciate you.
Please, Song of the Year. Tweet at me about this song. It's a beautiful song that this did not win Song of the Year.
It's a damn fucking shame.
I don't think it won anything. But
one slap of the week, baby.
Yeah, one slap of the week.
We have slap of the week.
I don't even know if I have one now.
Dove Vacadon slap of the week.
What do you got, Colin?
Lewis Capaldi, I'm here for you.
I'm not gonna play our full ones. I'm gonna play like a minute of mine, and I'll play like a minute of Colin's.
Right. All right,
we just did 6 minutes of Lewis Capaldi.
It was beautiful. I'm gonna cry.
If you're gonna go with mine, I really can't get off fucking Juice WRLD kick right now, so I'll do Empty by Juice WRLD, which is kind of that same
damn,
like that rasp he does with his voice. It's like Empty, I feel so goddamn empty.
Yeah, shit is fire.
It's like it's one of those songs you're listening to and you're like,
yeah. That beautiful piano.
Back it up.
From the unknown, whoa, whoa, whoa. I ran away, I don't think I'm coming back home. Whoa, 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 whoa. Like a crawl space, it's a dark place I roam. Ain't no right way, just the wrong way I know. My problems solved with styrofoam. My war revolves around a black hole. The same black hole that's in place of my soul. All empty. I feel so goddamn empty. I may go wrong. Tip me, big bullet holes.
God knows.
I'm keeping it real, real.
As a rock guy,
keeping it real.
Do you like, can you see it in like Juice WRLD's melodies and shit? How when he sings?
Oh, 100%. I mean, it makes me feel like I was at Vibs' house Friday night and Juice WRLD came on the Alexa and Vibs was literally doing it. Was, what do you call it? Lucid Dreams. And Vibs is like, I still feel the shadows in my room. Like
The fucking Roan Blink-182 accent.
And it's so true. Like, you can hear that through that. That's why it's like, I don't know, like it relates to like everyone, I feel like.
It's genre blend.
Yeah.
It's sick. It sucks that like a lot of people saw that and we're on the cusp of like Lil Peep's doing it, but Juice WRLD did it more commercially, like the emo rap shit, and it sucks.
I was thinking today actually as I was walking into work, I was listening to probably that song, I don't know. And I was just like, we'll never hear another. I mean, we might hear other Juice WRLD songs, but like, we'll never hear a true new Juice WRLD song ever again.
Like something sucks. About something current or anything like that. It's fucked up.
R.I.P.
I don't know. Well, I'm gonna stay, I guess, in the kind of sad song lane, but this song went viral, and it's called Rascal by a rapper called RMR. So I looked at it earlier today. It had 600 views when I first viewed it. It has 49,000 today recently because it just was going viral. Everyone was tweeting it. I tweeted about it. It's basically, it's a Rascal Flatts cover. It's covering a Rascal Flatts song. I don't remember what the fucking
life
song was.
Life is a highway.
No, you're going to recognize it when I play it, but it's this fucking hood-ass dude with a bunch of guns and a Saint Laurent bulletproof vest covering a Rascal Flatts song. And he just talks about robbing people and like fuck the police and shit. And it's pretty ridiculous. It's called Rascal by RMR.
They pour down like rain. I put on that old song that we danced to and then I head back to the trap, cause not much has changed. I've been hurt and fucked up too many years ago. Hoping I could come up quick along the broken road. But I hustled and found a plan to put me astride, show me love. Now I'm flexing in a wreck, they hating on me too. And every sleepless night led me to where I am. Bitches that broke my heart, they became holes I stand. Show me a better way. Promise I'll play this game. This much I know it's true. I came up and so could you. And fuck the boys
and Jesse, that was the worst trash I've ever heard
was
in my
fucking fire
life.
Yo,
I would have rather
bugging.
Listened to your last week's fucking techno
100 Gex?
Yeah, fire. That again.
No, dude.
That was the most trash I've ever
heard. This guy is going to be huge. I promise you. Watch.
I don't, he just went discredit viral. That.
That
I
just was think fire.
In my opinion, that was the most garbage thing I've ever heard. Rip off of a song.
Yeah, and
I could
that's
sing
the
fucking,
whole point.
I could write my own lyrics to the same beat of another song.
Dude, that's what literally all of rap is sampling and shit like that. It's just a remix. And it's a remix in a fire way. He talked about like fucking in the same melody as Rascal Flatts talked about selling drugs and shooting people. That shit's fire. You're bugging.
I didn't hate it.
I thought it was fucking fire.
I didn't hate it at all.
People online are going crazy about it, and the internet is never wrong.
I definitely didn't hate it. I liked it.
I didn't it hate cool it. I just thought it was trash.
You're of the silent majority. I thought you.
What do you mean you didn't hate it, but you thought it was trash?
Like it wasn't the like. Okay, yeah.
Saying it's
they
trash.
They took a good song and just put his own lyrics behind it with the same melody.
Dude, that's like a. Obviously, he's not going to fucking, if this gets big, like he's going to owe Rascal Flatts money, but it was like an ode to like how creative he was. He's like, oh, I'm a street dude. I have a sick voice. I'm going to take a country song, a legitimate country song, and remake it and sing it the same melody. Sing it better than the Rascal Flatts guy. He sounded better than the Rascal Flatts guy, I think. And flip it to my own, in my own bag. RMR Rascal. You're wrong on this one.
Trash of the week.
You're wrong on this
trash
one.
Trash of the week from
it.
Wayne Jetski.
I can't believe you didn't appreciate that. I'm actually kind of hurt. I thought you as a musician would appreciate it.
I don't look. I appreciate it because it's a Rascal Flatts song, and that's like.
So you don't think his vocals sounded good?
It sounded, yeah, their vocals sounded good, but it was like the lyrics. I was like, yeah, this is trash. If he wrote his own country song, maybe I'd be like,
all
right.
He wrote all the lyrics he wrote. He didn't.
Yeah, but I'm talking instead of ripping the fucking song. It's the same exact song.
But that's the whole point.
That's what I said. I could fucking go sing a Juice WRLD song with my own lyrics and be like, oh, this is fucking fire.
Not as good as he can.
Okay. All right. You know what? I'm going to record that song tonight on my guitar. I'm going to send it to you guys.
I just don't like that you're saying you don't like it because he covered a song. I loved it. Whatever. I'll be the sound.
Yeah, I liked it.
I guess we'll end on that. Me just being bitter.
I can have an opinion. We all got.
I know you can have an opinion.
Opinions are like
but
assholes. We all got one.
I'm vehemently opposed that your opinion's wrong on this one. I guess only time will tell.
Tweet at us and tell Jesse he's fucking wrong.
Yeah, you tell me I'm wrong, I guess.
And he owes us a fucking gallon challenge.
There's no gallon challenge until Colin proves that he's an RMR fan now, because that song was amazing.
Amazing is a lot.
I thought it was beautiful.
It's good. I enjoyed it. I thought it was creative, too. I enjoyed it.
Whatever.
I said I enjoyed it.
We're turning into the biggest RMR stand podcast.
I thought it was a decent tune.
All right, whatever. Take us out, dude. I'm done with you, folks.
All right. Thanks, everyone, for listening. God bless. Remember to follow us at 808 Smoke Breaks, Twitter, Instagram.
Hit that.
Plus at Wayne Jetski with two eyes, at The Real Colin Cooper, at Double Vodka Don, 808 Smoke Breaks. We'll see you next time.
See you next week.
Peace.